Hello everyone, I'm the Cetana Soul, and in this video we're going to be merging Flesh and Machine in Holy Matrimony, and we're going to be doing that with the Cybernetic Creed Origin, of course. Our ultimate goal will be to make every pop in the galaxy cybernetic in some way. And I want this achievement. And of course, the empire that we're going to be achieving these goals with is the Canva Church of Augmentation. These owls believe that organics and machines are flawed beings in the eyes of their god, and the perfect form is somewhere in the middle. Their society is run by a religious council that acts as both the church and the state. Now, the Canva themselves, they are long-lived creatures, where they also have a natural affinity for engineering, but they're also weak without their cybernetics, of course. A little bit weak, a little bit fragile. Cybernetics comes and helps that. I chose Venerable because, actually, I think it's the best trait for cybernetic pops, because with the cybernetic traits that you can add later on in the game, they do a lot of things, but they don't extend leader lifespan. Like, for example, if you went down synthetics, your leaders would last forever. And if you went down genetic ascension, there's many ways to increase your leader lifespan, but as far as I'm aware, there's no cybernetic enhancement that increases your leader lifespan, so I wanted to get it all in now, and then later on in the game, we can augment ourselves for more useful things, like drill arms, or integrated weaponry, or whatever. Whatever the galaxy calls for. But anyways, that is the long story short of this empire. It's a little bit shorter than normal, but that's because most of their story is yet to be written. It's going to be written amongst the stars. The Cybernetic Creed, of course, is a lore-heavy origin, and I have not played it yet, so yeah. These guys' story is going to be interesting to me, and hopefully to you, and it's going to be written amongst the stars more than anything. So let's get into the settings. We have a medium two-arm spiral galaxy here. 11 AI Empires, Synthetic Queen 3.5 times. Hopefully we can beat her and get that achievement. Speaking of achievements, we have Iron Man mode on, of course. Admiral late game scaling. Anything else you want to see, you can see and pause here. But yeah, one last thing before we get into the video. You guys liking, commenting, and subscribing really helps with the algorithm like so much. So if you could hit those funny little buttons for me, I'd really appreciate it. Anyway, let's start the video. Alright, here we are. Our sublime calling is the unification of flesh and machine. Our history is replete with failed attempts, yet guided by the divine will. We have now achieved the first stage of a sacred symbiosis with our ritualistic implants. We have only begun to touch on the boundless cybernetic potential. More advanced augmentations are yet to come. Despite this, our faith stands divided, with competing creeds disputing the end goal, disputing the end goals of sacred augmentation. Once we answer this question, the perfect union of holy flesh and blessed technology will allow us to improve the designs of evolution. To fuse is divine. Augmentation is worship. Okay, I haven't read that before. Let's go ahead and look at our cool new home world. We have Amphitheater of the Mind. Okay, this localized processing shrine allows the semi-connected choir of the mind to debate, share, and explore secrets of the material plane at the speed of light. Okay. Interesting. And we have a forge, we have the battlements of steel, and we have the sanctuary of toil. Oh, are those the different factions? I just realized these buildings, they probably represent the different factions. Okay, that's cool. Let's see what else we got here. Normal galaxy, how much? Okay, 19 size, normal home system. Okay, a 24 size world and a 12 size world, and then another 20 size world. Wow. And the 24 size world is a desert, so we can even inhabit that. That's real awesome. That's real lucky. Let's go ahead and get our military and our scientists out to explore. It looks like we also are in a really defendable point. Looks like we're at the end of this spiral. Huh. I don't think I could have asked for a better start. Well, maybe if there's like a ruined strategic coordination center here, that would be cool. Or a ruined matter decompressor here. That would be cool. Alright, we have an event. Guided by the divine towards the stars, various creeds within our faith now anticipate influence over the new government. Oh, we have our factions, okay. Each wields considerable sway over the faithful, advocating for the elevation of their members to influential positions and fulfilling their distinct spiritual needs. Only time will reveal if these diverse pressures will bring us closer to the divine or plunge us into chaos. Oh, we found another world. Hopefully they will be helpful. All right, so we have the four factions here. Let's check what our, okay, our scientist. Oh, wait, is that another 24 size desert world? Wow. This is a crazy start. Wow. Let's check out our factions here. Looks like the one that's winning so far is the Choir of the Mind. Let's go ahead and check them out. Oh, currently they all have the same goal. I assume they have a different description, though. Okay, they all have different descriptions, but unhallowed flesh. They would probably want cybernetics, right? Yeah. Okay, cybernetic implants, ruler of their ethic, representative of the council, pious. Okay, so they're all spiritualist factions, and they have different needs. I guess we can read them now. The commune of toil diligently oversees every humble worker and their augmentations, and profound belief in divinity of hard work propels their actions. Only those who tend to the roots can understand the divine. Okay, so workers, fellowship of the hammer, highest quality materials, their augmentations enhance the crafters of our empire. Okay, so like specialists, I'm guessing, or like at the very least, like industrial specialists, like people of the forge and whatnot, metallurgists and artisans. I assume those guys are in there. Then we have the Choir of the Mind, a quasi hive collective of researchers and engineers. The meditative trances serve as a means to instantly share information between members. Okay, so researcher faction. And the Temple of Steel safeguards our sacred body, cybernetics, and souls. This is the warlike faction, then. Augmentations enhance their rigorous training and combat prowess. Okay, sure. I really don't know which one we're going to go with. I guess it all depends. I don't have any plans because, well, I haven't played this origin before, so... Hammer Jubilee. The Jubilee Pilgrimage of the Fellowship of the Hammer is about to begin, and countless practitioners will journey from their local forges to the Forge of Fellowship in the capital. Traditionally, this event has caused countless logistical issues and often ends in outbursts of violence as the Fellowship eventually clashes with practitioners of the other creeds. Oh, wow. We're more divided than I thought, but okay. There have been calls to end this practice from the other creeds and those living in the capital. No, freedom of religion is a right. Disallow the pilgrimage. No, we're definitely not going to be doing that. Is it really appeasing these guys for... Okay, so governing ethics attraction minus 10%, pop amenities usage plus 10, monthly alloys plus 10%. Or I could have stability. Well, this is obviously the better option, like, overall. But we'll take the monthly alloys, I guess, because freedom of religion is a right, and I'm definitely not ready to oppress one of the religions yet. Definitely not. So, yeah, and we have gone down expansion first. Colonization fever is definitely what we have here, because there's so many planets in this little cluster, all behind this vortex. But yeah, for now, this is a crazy stronghold with a lot of planets behind it. More than enough to build up our empire before we go on our galactic crusade or whatever. Oh wow, wait, what? Is this seriously not connected to anything? Oh my god, it isn't. Wait, the choke point extends all the way to here. Wait, what? That's crazy, that is insane. And there's no wormholes or anything, no holes in our borders. Nothing, just all of these systems all behind this one choke point here now. I don't even know what to say. What about this system? It doesn't have a planet or anything. I still think probably the black hole is the best one, but yeah, we could incorporate two more worlds and a couple more systems if we just expand into here. Huh, crazy choke point. Well, just as I was colonizing our first world of merger, we have a scandal here. Undercover Creed agent. We have uncovered that Aeon Havoc has deep ties with the Templars of Steel. Okay, who is that? Who is that? Okay, our head of research. Okay, shouldn't they be with the Choir of the Mind? Interesting. Also the factions have changed up. Now most people want to be in the Commune of Toil. Okay, we'll have to see how that works. Anyway, they have both embezzled funds and reassigned projects towards the Creed's sphere of influence. Okay, the other Creeds are furious that this blatant abuse of power has been happening under the current administration's watch and are demanding Aeon Havoc be removed from power immediately. What should we do with this wayward leader? Well, I mean, they're actually really good. Oh wait, Aeon Havoc. Oh, they're crap. Okay, remove him from the position. He's done. He's gone. Yeah, this is... Yeah, he's gone. Goodbye, buddy. Welcome aboard... I don't know, someone else. You. You, Cypher Veer. Yeah, he's fired. Let's see, which science ship was that? Alright, this one. And welcome aboard Syl Hearth. Gotta be better than that corrupt leader that didn't have any positive traits to be on the council. Gotta be. Alright, we apparently met our first aliens, the Mem aliens, but I don't see them. We'll get Lark Helix on the case, but... Yeah, I don't know. Enigmatic Spacefarers. Okay, well, actually, just push forward then. I want to see if this is an actual empire or not.
Been cased.
No, not over there. Where is this thing here? Oh, look. Cypher Veer is already a much better head of research. So glad we fired Aeon or whatever his name was. Wait, where is this empire that we picked up? I don't see this any Mem alien. Oh, here they are. Here they are. They are Memillion and purple. Okay, wait, is this their home system? Oh, it is. And they are necrophages. Interesting. Okay. The Sek Lokar. And who is their primitive species? The Andari. Well, let's get out of this necrophage space because we don't know if they're peacefully converting those people or less peacefully converting them. The fire has gone out. The High Blacksmith, head of the Fellowship of the Hammer, has died suddenly. Despite being known for their outspoken behavior and decisive views. Is that supposed to be divisive? Okay, they had a cult following by members of the Creed. The Fellowship has requested them to receive an official state funeral, an honor usually reserved for our most beloved leaders. Unsurprisingly, the other creeds demanded that the state should have no part in burying this outspoken spiritual leader. How should we address the demands of the creeds? Okay, so... An honor usually reserved for our most beloved leaders. I mean, if people are calling for it, he sounds like a beloved leader, right? Spiritual ethics extraction, monthly alloys, monthly consumer goods plus 10%, stability minus 10, huh? I mean, okay, so it's not worth upsetting the other creeds, stability plus 10. I mean, he sounds pretty beloved, so I'm sorry. It's just gonna have to be stability minus 10, unfortunately.
Free real estate, preem.
Okay, we have a preem free real estate thing. Okay, it looks like this is gonna be a generator world. For now, at least. It's a 20 size world, one of our core worlds. I'm sure it'll be turned into something more important. Okay, we have another more generator type world here.
This system's secrets are ours.
What are these worlds good for anyway? This is a good mining world. Ooh, it's also a good generator world. Wow, we have a lot of generator worlds. We should have just been machines. Can't see that yet. Good farming world, but we're far away from using that. I guess we're gonna have to do most of our farming on our home world, which is kind of perfect for that, so I guess that makes sense. We have found more aliens to our north, this time anthropods. We don't see their home world. I would very much like to, so we get a better idea of what's going on. Is this their home world? Bam! Okay, first try. It's very standard home world. Let's see, they are materialists? That's not good. And egalitarians, okay. Okay, materialist egalitarians. They don't have any crazy traits. Okay, this just seems like a very standard empire. Alright, we've seen our two potential enemies, homeworlds. On to the next event, I guess. Controversial relics. Recently, an archaeological team has discovered an ancient religious site. Its existence was considered a myth, and has already forced some of us to revise our faith's historical records. The most surprising fact is that many of the uncovered historical artifacts have clear communion of toil iconography. The true faith. This information would prove that the commune is the original interpretation of our religion, a heavily debated topic in our faith. Well, that's actually pretty big. The original denomination, huh? The original interpretation? Anyway, officially acknowledging this revelation would please the Communion of Toil, but strategic silence would please the other creeds. I mean, can we really ignore the truth? I don't think so. Spiritual ethics attraction, worker pop output, monthly unity. Yeah, we gotta tell the truth here. I mean, this is our religion we're talking about. Should we hack these guys? No. No need to make enemies preemptively. We might want to be enemies with them in the future, but no need to do it now. Alright, we have our first ascension perk. Definitely we want to take... wait, do we have to take the flesh is weak or no? The flesh is weak, the flesh is weak. No, I don't see the flesh is weak, so we don't have to actually take that. Alright, cool. We'll do, technological ascendancy then. Alright, we established first contact with our first aliens. Let's just put them on screen.
External uplink established.
Sec Lucrin regime, a authoritarian militarist. Okay. Not against our ethics, but also not with them. I mean, I guess we're both militarists, so we're gonna go ahead and try to be as friendly with them as we can. This changes everything, blah blah blah. Let's see their colors pop up on the map. No. Let's go ahead and establish an embassy with them. Okay, they're cordial to us just because of a friendly greeting. We love to see that. Okay. There we go. So even if these guys are menaces, it should be fine. We can actually... I guess we... Okay, difficulty hell. Why are they so hard to get into contact with? I don't know. I also don't know why... Okay, there we go. Now we can see them. Divine implants. The faithful have unveiled the secrets of cybernetics to all. However, today marks the commencement of our journey, as we must now wholeheartedly embrace the divine future. It is time. We must take the cybernetics tradition to start the divine fusion. Okay. Well, when is that going to be? Oh, 4 months. 3 months. Oh, it is approaching. Okay, what do we want to research next? We'll do some armor. Why not? Alright, here we are. Let's go and find cybernetics. Here they are. Okay, so we don't even have to take the flesh as weak. That saves us a ascension slot. The conclave of fusion throughout history, our misguided attempts to augment our flesh have irreparably lacerated numerous divine vessels, leading to conflicted interpretations of the divine fusion among different creeds. This is a cool picture. This guy's like yelling at this guy, and he's yelling at him. That is so cool. Anyway, as technology finally enables full augmentation, the holy leaders of our faith, the Technofants... How many Technofants do we have? Just one Technofant pop. I assume we'll get more as our worlds grow, but anyway. As technology finally enables full augmentation, the holy leaders of our faith, the Technofants, convened a conclave. Its purpose is to establish the core principles of our church, merging the individual creeds into a unified dogma. Okay. Okay, may the divine guide them, for sure. Okay, divine fusion. It is an event, or sorry, a situation. Our society has long strived toward the perfection of union of flesh and machine, and the time for them to take the ultimate journey has become. To fuse is divine, augmentation is worship. Pops to receive holy implants next month, 0. Engineering research, minus 20. Well, it's a good thing we have natural engineering research. Where can we see that again? Yeah, here. Natural engineers, plus 15%. Oh, and our ritualistic implants are doing pretty good, too. Engineering from jobs, plus 5%. Unity from jobs, plus 10%. Overall worker resource output. Wow, that counters the weakness. Army damage, plus 5%. That doesn't counter that weakness, but... Okay. Divine fusion, I mean...
Council agenda ready.
Definitely not against that. So I have to wonder if the Conclave of Fusion actually is going to merge all of our factions together, because isn't that like a core part of the game? I mean, this situation could is going pretty fast for us to lose all of our very opposing factions, but oh, here we go. The Fusion of Fate. Yeah, this is all going so fast. Like, I barely can talk to another empire before this has all happened, but all right. Forming the Conclave of Technofants was arduous, but each of the most important creeds demanding representation in the conclave. Okay. After some deliberation, the Fellowship of the Hammer, the Templars of Steel, the Choir of the Mind, and the Commune of the Toil, Commune of Toil were all invited. The Conclave now approaches their divine task with fiery conviction. The first decree demands an increase in tithes, or mandated community service, from the general population. We must choose how to support the Conclave. More options will now become available to the situation. Okay. Well, let's see them. Ooh, let's see them. Extra funds. People powered. Okay. Resources from jobs, minus 10%. Versus monthly energy credits, minus 20%. Versus church funded. Monthly unity, minus 20%. Okay, well, we'll go with people powered. Just get that minus 10% on all jobs evenly across the board, so we're not suffering too heavily in one thing. Okay, repulsive bugs. Alright, people don't like how these guys look. Okay, they're isolationist, which is perfect. Isolationists just sit there until we declare war on them. That's how I like them. As we began to pick up more and more visual images of the aliens known as Aleph aliens, it was inevitable that these images would be leaked to the public. Their appearance has proven delightful and are now impatient to make closer acquaintance. What? You just called them repulsive. Okay, as we begin to pick up more visual images of the aliens known as Aleph aliens, it is inevitable that we would eventually be leaked. The pictures would be leaked to the public. Their appearance has provoked widespread dismay amongst our populace, describing them as repulsive bugs. Okay, their appearance has proven delightful to the canvas public versus their appearance has provoked widespread dismay. Huh. Okay, well, I guess that's like a bug where you can get both of those. Either that or half of our population is really into the bugs and half of them really, really are not. The Codex of Augmentation, the second decree of the Conclave of Technophants, is a call to formalize the faith. For too long, the differences between the various creeds have caused friction in our society. Well, you can say that again. The major creeds all make a compelling case for a unified faith, while more moderate voices argue for a truly open and inclusive path. Okay. Okay, so wait, are we choosing already what path we want to go down? The Fellowship of Hammer shall build a brighter future. Templars will protect our flesh. The Choir of the Mind will sing our progress. Okay. We should end these divisive dogmas. The creeds shall be reformed into unified creeds, allowing every faithful vessel to be modified. Okay. All buildings associated with the other creeds will be replaced with temples. This creed will remain as the only spiritualist faction. Factions belonging to non-spiritualist ethics will be removed, will be allowed to form. Oh, okay. This dogma will form into the Commune of Toil. All buildings associated with the other creeds will be replaced with temples. This creed, okay. So we're getting rid of our cool buildings already? Huh. What if I, like, don't want to? I gotta pick one, I guess, because I don't want to lose all of my cool buildings. Okay, so this fortress church houses both the armory and the training grounds for the battle-ready Templars of Steel. They stand ever vigilant to protect our divine flesh. That's cool. Yeah, these buildings are like so cool. We have to get rid of all of. Okay. So I guess we'll go with the Templars. The dogma will form around the creed of Templars of Steel. All buildings associated with the other creeds will be replaced. Okay, so we're actually just choosing. Alright, well, I guess we'll go with the Templars of Steel, because we are doing a more warlike thing this game. Alright, well, I guess that's what we're doing. Faction founded, the military-industrial complex. Okay, cool. Alright, the Templars of Steel are like a more militarist faction. Okay, well.
That upgrade was well worth the alloys.
Oh, they upgraded. They upgraded this. There's 7 soldier jobs now. Only four. With 7 priests. Oh, the priests come from here. Well, what is this building good for? It says 12 soldier jobs. I don't see 12 soldier jobs. Oh, only 4 soldier jobs. Sorry. Technophant jobs, house. Okay. So we have another Technophant. Alright. Well, let's build another industrial district to employ these specialists. Okay, well, I guess we've gone down the Templars of Steel. Whatever that means. I guess we'll figure that out in the future. I didn't know that we were going to be shoehorned into picking a faction right at the beginning. Okay, Battlements of Steel. Okay, we can build them on other planets too. That's cool. Huh. Yeah, right at the beginning, we're shoehorned into a certain faith. So I guess the Civic is really built for replayability. Because right at the beginning, we made a choice that affects kind of the rest of the game here. The False Faiths. After choosing the Templars of Steel, the other creeds protested. Many believe that the Conclave has turned against the true faith. Well, I mean, should have saw that one coming. So far, the protests have been heated but peaceful. Only time will tell whether these sparks result in real flames. Okay, whatever comes next, we must decide the fate of the other creeds. Some have called for outright excommunication, labeling their dogma heresy. The turmoil they have caused, good evidence of their blasphemy. Others believe mercy is the way forward, asking us to show tolerance towards the misguided members of our faith. So we can either suppress other creeds or tolerate other creeds. I guess we'll tolerate them. Yeah, we'll tolerate them. That's fine. I don't really want to oppress my own people as much as I want to, Yeah. Dedication to the unified dogma has spread amongst the people, with most practitioners of various creeds having disavowed their old ways. Everyone apart from the true fanatics are preparing their divine flesh for the final transformation. Final transformation? We're like 17 years into the game, alright. They work quick. The truth of our divine fusion prevails. Unified faith, stability plus 10, unity plus 10%. Okay, well, that seems to be the way to go there. They just came around. Okay, the Aleph aliens have... Yeah, just go ahead. Oh, we chose the wrong option here. Alright. A direct democracy. Okay, well, we'll be nice to them anyway. They closed their borders. They're suspicious of us. Probably mainly because we contacted them in the wrong form of speech. Alright, well, gotta have some enemies in the galaxy, I suppose, if we're gonna be warlike anyway. Yeah, that was all very quick, but I guess we are the Templars of Steel now. Let's see. Let's read it one more time. The Templars of Steel safeguard our sacred body, cybernetics, and souls. Augmentations enhance their rigorous training and combat prowess. Well, that should help us in our crusade against the actual heretics. While I didn't choose to, prosecute any heresy within our own faith, heresy outside of our empire definitely will be prosecuted, and the Templars of Steel will be the ones doing it. Let's see, the Tithe of Time. As the Grand Fusion draws near, we look back to a long-standing tradition of the faith, the Tithe of Time. For countless generations, every faithful member of society has given a portion of their time and energy to the Church, like Divine Fusion. Okay, oh, like Divine Fusion, this service acts to help us strengthen the body of the faith. How shall the faithful best support the divine augmentation? The tithe of the army? The tithe of the navy? Oh, wait, is this permanent? Each year, the faithful of our population will dedicate a portion of their time to naval service. Okay. Okay, that's like a permanent effect. Plus 10% naval capacity, wow. Okay, and is that just because we had Distinguished Admiralty, or is that only helped by the fact that we had Distinguished Admiralty? Because The army one kind of sucked. I'm definitely glad we had Distinguished Admiralty if that was the only way to get tied to the Navy. Because, I would have been real sad if our playthrough just... we chose the faction that boosts our army damage. Ugh, that would be terrible. Blood and Circuits. The time for Divine Fusion is finally upon us. I mean, you say finally, but it's only 20 years into the game. Anyway, it is time for us to construct holy augmentation centers on our worlds, and the process can begin. To fuse is divine, augmentation is worship. Full cybernetic augmentation has begun for the faithful. All other actions of the conclave will halt until the divine fusion is complete. Okay, build an augmentation center to resume the conclave of fusion situation. Okay, well, I guess we'll build one on our home world. What is it? Anyway, let's take a look at it. Oh, it's the regular augmentation center. Okay, augmenter jobs plus two. Yeah, this is the regular augmentation center, but it has a different description down there. A sanctum of transcendent augmentation where the faithful converge to be reborn through divine fusion. Okay, so this is like the same building, even has the same look, but it's got a different description for the faithful. All right, the augmentation center has been built, and the future of our flesh is on the table here. The future of flesh. Alright, as we complete our divine journey, our vessels finally achieve the holy fusion of machine and flesh. One final step for the faithful is the installation of holy augments. The Templars of Steel demand the faithful be made into holy weapons. Oh no, is it actually going to be army damage? Oh, I don't even want to look. To align with the fusion of our bodies, our government will now fully embrace cybernetics and undergo a restructuring. The Tribunal of Technophants will be created. To fuse is divine. Augmentation is worship. The Templars of Steel will now forge a new era. Okay. Let's go ahead and read that new era. The faithful will gain the aspect of the Templars of Steel, a unique series of holy and unmodifiable augmentations, unlocks full effects of tradition cybernetics. Our authority has changed to cybernetic focus, oligarchic cyber theocracy. Okay. Oligarchic cybernetic governments have a privileged group of highly augmented individuals who retain total political power, steering their cybernetic society with unmatched precision. Okay, cool. Unlocks Edict, the Crusade of Steel, ends the Cybernetic Creed event chain. Alright, elevated Templar modifiers, organic species modification points, and naval capacity. Okay, good. Nothing to do with army damage. We love to see that. Species points. Do we get something robotic? Okay, we do. How worth it is it right now to upgrade our synthetic bodies? What am I looking for here? Oh yes, traditions. We are 25 months away from having all of cybernetics done, so I'm gonna wait until that happens, and then we'll augment our steel machines of combat prowess. Elevated Templars plus 5% naval capacity. Yeah. Ours. Very cool. All right, here we are. Augmenters per augmentation center. Bam, the cybernetics tree is done. I don't know. Do we want anything right now for our ascension perk? No, I don't think we do. All right. Let's go ahead and augment our species, which we absolutely love to do. We have Super Canva and Super Canva. Okay. Trait picks 3. Okay. So we can have delicate form, abrasive implants, utilitarian augments. Okay. Scarcity algorithms, energy credits, neural limiters, high bandwidth. Okay, I think high bandwidth is definitely worth it. Then we'll do universal augmentations, and then one final thing we have. One the final thing. Do we want to do learning algorithms for our leaders? I think. Energy credits. It increases energy credits though, so I don't know if I really want to do that. Durable amenities upkeep. Huh, where's the regular minus upkeep? I mean, just amenities upkeep, we can keep on top of that. That's not an issue. What do we want here? I guess we will go with learning algorithms for now. We can always change it later, but let's go ahead and do that and apply that to all of our species that we can here. We have 9 pops that I guess are in the militarist faction. Oh, that's their own fault. Oh, we actually never looked at the Crusade of Steel, and it is pretty good. To guard against the fiends attacking our divine flesh, we must fully support the Templars of Steel. Amen. Ensuring our warriors always are prepared. Naval capacity plus 10%, ship fire rate plus 10%, army damage plus 10%. Okay, you know what? You gave us some ship fire rate. I'm allowing you guys to talk about armies and not be upset. Wow, that's actually really good. I can't even say that that's not. Yeah, we'll definitely take that. And we might even need that for our upcoming war against the Sovereignty. They have made claims against us, which are idle threats, of course. But yeah, threats that we're going to take serious nonetheless. But before we go to war with those guys, I did want to start and make our first megastructure an arc furnace in this system right here. There we go. We're going to make an arc furnace to further fuel our economy. I mean, we're doing decent on minerals, but we could definitely use some more industrial base. Probably going to do that on our homeworld. Oh, we need some more housing here. Damage to star bases is pretty good. Speaking of star bases, and speaking of our war with these guys, I have built up this star base a good amount to where, well, if they want entrance into the rest of our systems, they're definitely going to have to fight for it. And in case you didn't catch it, I made this station here our shipyard so that our ships are built here, our fortress that we have to defend the rest of our entire territory is right next to it, and it's all very nice, all very nice and well thought out. Yeah, another thing is I kind of want to invite our BFFs over here. I actually, oh, they're claiming us more. See, this is what I was talking about, these claims, these threats. I want to do only 7 energy credits, not worth. I wanted to do communications. You know, I'll just give you the communication. There you go. So you can see these guys. These contacts aren't your standard users. We found some more people. All right, let's go ahead and research them. Okay, so now you know these guys, right? Oh, but they won't attack. Will not join because they have no interest in taking any war goals against the Sovereignty. Will not join your war against because the Sovereignty because their forces are not sufficiently built up. Well, maybe that'll change in the future. But yeah, I just gave them our communication so they can see these guys and maybe help us in our war. But you know, we don't really need them. We have the Templars of Steel on our side. Oh, wrong button. The Templars of Steel on our side. We don't even have another faction anymore, which is perfect. Our friends here think they're too weak to survive in the galaxy and want to be vassalized, which I guess that does make sense. We are pretty strong, and they wouldn't even take on these guys, which I assume are also probably, you know, also probably not as strong as us, I assume. I don't really know, but we do have a cruiser in our fleet. Oh, wow. Let's see it. A beautiful Nexus-class cruiser. The cruiser Church Azure Bliss. Well, with our wonderful cruiser, the Azure Bliss, I think it's time that we do our first war against these guys here. I might be overplaying my hand here just a little bit, but I do think that we can defeat these guys in battle. Let's go ahead and do that. That's just a net bonus. And I think, I don't know, I guess we'll make some armies. I don't really know which ones to do it with. I mean, I guess I can do it with these guys. Anyway, yeah, we're gonna make some armies, we're gonna move our fleet out, and we're gonna see how
trace complete we got.
How well we do in this war, really. I don't actually know if they're stronger than us or not, but hopefully not, I guess. Okay, we have our war doctrines. Can we do no retreat? Oh, we can do no retreat as well. Okay. Yeah, definitely we want to do no retreat. We are Templars of Steel. Is that right? Templars of Steel? Where is the factions? Yeah, the Templars of Steel. We do not retreat from battle. I suppose we'll wait until we can build another cruiser. And yeah, let's just get this war going.
Hostilities engaged. Let's show them what we can do.
Here is the moment of truth. Have I messed up? Relative naval strength plus 13. Oh, okay. I have not messed up. We are way stronger than these guys, which is excellent.
Attempting brute force entry on an enemy station.
We're going to be taking these systems. I think the only thing I really messed up on is not asking for more systems, which I can always make up for by doing it now. Oh, we have some fleets coming in. Let's go ahead and smash them to pieces.
Time for a trace.
They left. I guess we... Oh no, we take out this fleet. Alright, let's take out that fleet too. And it is smashed. How many ships do we lose? It looks like we lost a destroyer and a corvette. I think we had 20 corvettes and 10 destroyers. That makes sense to me. Let's go ahead and make this guy an admiral. And I guess move in on their home system. Let's go ahead and take this home system too. I don't know why I was so conservative when it came to claiming systems. I wasn't sure we were even stronger than these guys, I guess, but we definitely were, so let's get our armies over there too. Alright, this is going excellently. Ooh! Oh, I thought they retreated to here. Oh, they did! Oh, now we're really smashing them. Oh, wow. Good job, Templars. Yeah, this is our true calling. War. Only 270. Wow, we can... Hold on. How far away are our armies? 106. We need to hire them a general. Armchair general, no. Are you guys good at being a general? No, not really. Okay, we'll try out you. Are you good at doing anything besides being a trickster? Okay, you can live long. That's kind of cool. Okay, you are a general now.
Game-changing upgrades incoming.
By the time they reach here, the homeworld should be bombed enough to take it. Oh man, this is awesome. And I'm gonna go ahead and build another cruiser, another flagship for our fleet. This is going real well. Alright, well, our armies have arrived, but the bombing of the planet has not gone totally according to plan. There is still a large amount of armies on there. Okay, they're dying a lot faster now, which is good. We found some Holy Guardian fanatic purifiers. Okay, we have our second cruiser flagship, the Cruiser Church Netrunner. Okay, go ahead, Netrunner, join the main fleet. Let's see, are we ready for invasion yet? Soon. Let's see where our armies are. I know armies are coming to back us up. Okay, we have an incursion of ships, which should be completely fine. Ooh, okay, we cannot jump into that system with our armies. I guess we'll just land these armies. Yeah, alright, go ahead. Land the armies, and we're gonna go ahead and use this station to heal our ships.
On-site invasion initiated. Let's get
bam. Two cruisers, which is awesome. Invasion over. Their homeworld is taken. Alright. And they're trying to retake this station. They won't be able to. Okay, well they are, but we'll take it right back. Yeah, they weren't able to hold that. Are they pushing into our armies? No, not yet. Alright, let's go ahead and free up the rest of our armies. Ooh, they are getting kind of surrounded though.
Spaceport breach detected. We're under siege.
Let's just move them to some distant part of space. Where is our military? Oh, did we win a space battle? Or did they retreat? Wait, where was the fleet that was right here?
Spaceport offline.
I don't know, but I guess we might as well attack this fleet.
Time for some new chrome.
And merge these armies together. Bam. I wonder if these guys could make the trek back and invade this world. Someone's trying to connect. Yeah, I think they'll probably be able to do that. Hopefully they don't get caught by anyone. Someone's trying to connect. Mixing it up with a hostile fleet. Alright, we got their fleet out of our systems. Awesome. Yeah. I think we just need to take the systems that we promised to take. Let's go ahead and claim that system too. Where are our enemies here? Alright, make claims. I want this system as well. There we go. Non-aggression pact, nope. Alright. War pretty much won. General V. Aether has won his land battle. Let's go ahead and get him to follow the fleet once again. Oh man, they just gave up even though we didn't take half the systems that we wanted. And we got a bunch of new factions. That's absolutely not what we want. But we did get this strip of land, which is exactly what we want. So now we are connected to these guys who are receptive to us. Okay. Well, I'll be receptive. Until we take out these guys, of course. They want a non-aggression pact, though. No. I like being receptive as much as the next guy, but yeah, non-aggression pact, that's not really gonna happen, unfortunately. I guess we can keep this as a shipyard. Why not? It's right on our enemy's borders. So we love to see that. We got some debris here. Let's go ahead and dock them at the shipyard. This can remain an anchorage. That's completely fine. Let's take a look at our new planets over here. We have Cithar, their homeworld. Research labs. I guess we'll rebuild their research labs. They have a bioreactor. Huh. Okay, so these guys are full citizens? Or no, they're residents. Okay, well they need to be assimilation into the cybernetic mind. Yeah, that's what they need to be. Okay, we moved in some Canva to be the technophants. That's good. And these guys will be assimilated into our faith and our cybernetics. And same here. Okay. All right, pretty seamless transition of power. I can't complain. Oh, we should probably set our default species rights to assimilation because, yeah, we're going to be assimilating everyone. Our fleet with 6 cruisers, count them up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 cruisers is getting ready to reattack the sovereignty of, what is it, Kithlar? Whatever. It doesn't really matter. We're going to, should we make them our tributary? I mean, maybe. We have, okay, let me show you my claims first. We have the majority of their empire claimed. And I haven't claimed this part of the empire, one, because we're out of influence, but two, because I'm actually going to invite the entity down here, this hive mind creature that doesn't hate us too much, this entity to go and attack them, because these systems were actually the entities before the sovereignty of Cathar took them from them, so they'll be getting them back in this war, and then maybe, I don't know, maybe we make the rest of them our tributary or our vassal. Nah, we should probably just outright claim them, so let's go ahead and do that. Safety's off. For right first. Now, let's go ahead and tell our ships to get in there. Oh, wait! I forgot to invite our friends. Well, too late for that now, I suppose, but yeah, I mean, there was no really point to inviting the entity into this war other than, I don't know, I usually don't get to invite empires into wars too often. We'll take that artifact Trace off your complete. Hands, thank you. Let's see. Are we finding any resistance here? Probably not. More space for a mega block is available. We're gonna go ahead and take all of these systems. Attempting brute force entry on an enemy station. Stability minus 20. Whoa, what happens? Wait, hold on. Okay, we'll donate, sure, for the influence. But what happened? Is it this world? Ooh, stability minus 20 on this world is not good. I just got the amenities to, like, acceptable levels. Alright, let's go ahead and get rid of this stupid commercial building and build another holo theater to get amenities back up. Again, with the, stupid AI, never putting amenities on their worlds. I had to build a amenities on both of these worlds. See, look, there's no amenities on this world being produced, and there was none on this world. I just stabilized the stability, but now we have bribed officials. We see the enemy. A 2K fleet. Alright, is it even worth engaging? Nah, we'll go and engage them later. Let's take the rest of these systems. Alright, we've taken the systems. I think every system that we currently have claimed. We're going to go ahead and land our armies on this very last world, and then they should surrender. I assume. Unoccupied claims. Okay, we took the planet, but apparently we have unoccupied claim. Oh, this right here. Okay. Anything else?
Trace complete. We got him.
Unoccupied systems. Unoccupied planets. Wait, what other planet do we have claimed? Do we have this planet claimed? No, but we could. Should we claim this planet, or should we claim this system? I feel like we should clean up our borders by claiming this system. And then what planet do we not have occupied? Oh, we forgot to invade this planet while we were at it. Oh, okay. Alright, let's go ahead and do that. I guess we can go fight their fleet while we're at it. Man, they only have 2K left? I remember when they had several 2K fleets. We really messed their army up, huh? Kind of upgrade that, reinforce that.
Time for some new chrome.
Oh, they have another army.
On-site invasion initiated. Navy. Let's get it.
A 500.
Enemy planet secured. Assuming network control. All right.
Bam. War over. Okay, best possible outcome, and we have another one of their worlds. This one, even worse than the other ones. Oh. Alright. Raider slavers have just landed on one of our new planets and took some of our- wait! Oh, okay. Okay, it took the pops that we don't really care about. That's really fine, but actually it's not fine. Because they messed with the wrong type of cyborgs. They messed with the Templar of Steel. So we'll be waiting for them in this system for when they leave. Okay, they're leaving. And we are set up in this system with a 20K fleet. And we are not about to let them get away with doing what they did to us. Okay. We have definitely lost some ships in that battle. But that is completely fine. We have won. And we have shown the raiders that we are not to be messed with. And also, we did a little bit of house cleaning when it came to our old ships. Let's go ahead and upgrade our new ships and... Yeah, oh wait, I closed out the battle, but it's pretty obvious to see what we lost. Amoeba Swarm. Yeah, we lost some destroyers, we lost some corvettes. I think we may have lost one or two cruisers, but...
Another firewall cracked.
Overall, definitely a large success. Oh, more crime. This world is just not going to get stabilized, huh?
Alright, just as we're reorganizing our vassal contract with our friends up here, the other people want to be our vassals too, which I guess makes sense, but I'm not sure I really want them to. I mean, that is kind of our way of expansion. I guess we could theoretically experience some peace and simply... integrate them, I guess? But I'm not sure I really want to do that. They are pacifist spiritualists. They are just desperate for everything with us. They are pathetic, of course. Alright, well, I guess I can just go to war with the entity down here and just... I don't know, kill all of their pops? It kind of sucks, because I didn't really want to kill the entire hive mind as of yet, but if our ultimate goal is to make sure every pop in the galaxy is cybernetic, then these pops, well, they kind of go. They kind of gotta go, I mean. Although you are not part of us, you will become... Wait, what did he say? Especially, our wrath is a terrible thing to behold. Okay, now I feel less bad on declaring war on them. First they were talking about being our friends, but now they're talking about their wrath. Eh, whatever. Sure, I'll let these guys a part of our be a part of our empire. And I guess the entity's gotta go next.
Booting up a new colony.
Either that or...
External uplink
established. I don't know. These guys are gonna have to get integrated real soon. 55 months. Oh, man. So, we need to wait 55 months for that to happen. And probably a lot more months on top of that. I don't know. Probably gonna take a while. Alright, it's that time again where we go to war with the sovereignty. And I think this will be the last time, assuming nothing goes absolutely terribly wrong. Let's go ahead and upgrade these ships.
We've constructed
something. What did we just research that's so important? Oh, okay. Like I said, it's kind of important. We'll go with that. I mean, it's really not that important, to be honest. Yeah, it's not that important. We can just go and take them out. We have our borders closed, of course. Our head of research. Do they already have the Inquisitor thing? Okay, no. Now we have two Inquisitors in our Empire. So now we have two more research alternatives for every tech. That's pretty cool. Divine, die in order. Hello. Alright, we're here.
Strap in.
Let's go ahead and declare this war. We have 9 claims on them. Bam. Safety is off. Frag the shipyard first. I mean, that's pretty good advice, actually. Where's our army? Oh, our army's already following. Okay, yeah, we don't even need to bring in our second fleet for this. Or our third fleet, I suppose. Alright, they're bringing in their fleet. I assume it's going to be absolutely crushed. Yep, it's gone. And now we just take all of their star bases.
Build job complete.
Bam, bam, bam.
Another firewall cracked.
Bam. Oh, their fleet has returned.
Attempting brute force entry on an enemy station.
Okay, let's go ahead and set them to go kill this thing first. What's left of them?
We're under attack. Time to dance.
And yeah, they're gone. Okay, let's see the battle report. Yeah, they're pretty much gone. Alright, we just finished the terraforming of all of our core worlds, which is excellent. Let's go ahead and do Marvelous, some nice little amenities there. Okay, let's choose our research spot. Research complexes, that could be pretty good. Yeah, we're gonna have to colonize all of these worlds, and I also just took their last station here, so now we just have to invade these worlds, and the sovereignty is no more. Next on our target list is probably the entity, and then whatever this Opalag Empire is over here. Oh, it's robots. Or no, it's a robot is in charge, but we have this founder species that's looking a little virtual. I guess we'll see what's happening when we invade them, but for now I have no idea. We just took their world here with our wonderful armies. Only 19% devastation on the planet. We will take that, but a galactic community is being built. So, I mean, that'll probably open up our eyes to the rest of the galaxy. Of course, we'll join. There we go. The end of the sovereignty. We accept your surrender. Okay, the sovereignty is gone. Oh, the galactic community hasn't formed yet. It is forming. Okay. Well, soon we'll be able to see the rest of the galaxy. Let's go ahead and downgrade this station. This station is useless to us. This station is also useless to us. We can keep this one maybe as like an anchorage. Yeah, we'll keep that one as like an anchorage. This can stay as what it is, and this station is useless to us. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's check out our new worlds. We have a fortress world with a commercial zone. Okay, well, we're gonna have to change that. That is a nonsense world setup.
This system's secrets are ours.
And let's see our other new world. It's currently just a holo theater with some cities. Alright, I respect it. Yeah, we'll fix those worlds up, but okay, where is Heart being located? Oh, that's outside of the core sector? That's a shame. Well, anyway, we have a lot of territory now, and I guess, yeah, the next people we're gonna invade is unfortunately the entity. And I say unfortunately because, well, their pops can't become cybernetic, they just have to die. So, not really what we wanted to do. We didn't want to engage in too much genocide this game, but I mean, unless these guys are willing to be integrated soon. Okay, they kind of are willing to be integrated soon, actually. There we go. Will they still be loyal to us even as they're being integrated? They're going to be loyal to us, huh? All right. Well, maybe the entity doesn't have to die. We are currently integrating those guys. We have another tradition. I don't know what we want yet for that. I mean, we have been getting some really good leaders. So I could go statecraft or something else, but domination would also be good. Harmony would be good. I think for our empire, Council harmony is the best. And then for the last two, I'll decide if I want to go down the leaders' trees or not. But anyway, the galactic community has been born, and all right, we Someone's can see everything. The Sloth Automation Guild. We see a united Sleperon territories.
Time for some new chrome.
Oh, we have another big hive mind over here. All right, well, it's unfortunate they're gonna have to die. All right, well, we can see most of the rest of the galaxy here, and oh, we're the strongest. We love to see that with the Sloth Automation Guild being in second place. We have just researched anti-gravity engineering, which of course means that we are going to grab the Arcology Project and start our first city world. We have a lot going for us right now as a nation. A very, very large amount. Let's go ahead and insert some gene clinics and a temple before the Arcology Project comes up, because we have some unemployed people. Honestly, the Arcology Project could probably work here too as well. Oh no, we have a deep sinkhole, okay. But either way, we are about to have an Arcology Project. We're about to integrate these guys, and our first battleships have arrived on the battleship on the battlefield, and they are a thing of beauty. And we are in fact attacking the entity next, but I've decided that I'm going to spare them for now and just vassalize them. So, oh, they have marauders attacking them, interestingly enough. But yeah, we gotta push this advantage. We are so much stronger than pretty much any empire in the galaxy at this point, and there's no reason not to push this advantage. I don't think anyone else has battleships as of the moment. If they do, I mean, their fleet power doesn't show it. Let's go ahead and look at the galaxy screen again, and yeah, it looks like the second most powerful person in the galaxy is our vassal, and then the Sloth Automation Guild, let's see, from fleets 184, as you can see right there, and then right here we have from fleets 1,231, we're significantly ahead when it comes to fleet power, and it's all thanks to our wonderful Templars of Steel. I am actually glad that we went with them. Oh, and we're killing off the other factions, that's good. Eventually they'll all be converted. Let's go ahead and upgrade these arc furnaces. Yeah, we have two more arc furnaces as well. Things could not be going better, really. Whoa, where are you going? You need to stay there. Alright. Let's pick an engineering research. I guess we can go with the Stormfire auto cannons for now. Actually, let's go with the alloy nanoplants. Do we have volatile motes? We have enough. Let's go ahead and pick leader lifespan. Do this. Alright, I think we're all ready to go. Let's go ahead and declare this war. Vassal, make tributary. Yeah, we want them to be our tributary too. Alright, let's go ahead and get in there with our battleships, these guys, with our cruisers. See what our battleships can do in war. Okay, we took this place. Oh, we see their fleets. We have an 8.6k fleet here. We'll go take that out.
Attempting brute force entry on an enemy station.
Okay, I don't think we lost any ships in that battle, which is good. Let's go and take this. Let's go ahead and see this world. 151, 151. Okay, our armies can take those out. Bam. We are building new armies over here. Okay, we have 400 new armies ready and waiting. In fact, we should just make more. And send these guys off to... we'll just tell them to invade this planet. Our armies have regrouped with each other. It should be no problem taking these worlds out now. Nope. Commander V Aether will be taking these worlds with ease, of course. Let's go ahead and take this world next. Oh. our colony gained. Oh, we vassalized, or sorry, we integrated. Oh, relics gained from integration. Wait, what did we gain relic wise? We got the Omni Codex. Okay. Cool. Yeah, that's cool. I really don't feel like dealing with that in the middle of a war. Figuring out all of the specifics of all of those planets. And we'll probably... our empire is probably big enough that we can just start hitting that good old automation button. But I don't know. Oh, we got a faction. We have a rift in space. We have low stability on a lot of planets. Probably because they're all being assimilated, which makes a lot of sense. Let's take the planets that are the most messed up right now and start putting some technofants on there. There we go. They just need some technofants. They just need some technofants to show them the way, and then they'll be fine. There we go. Alright, no more stability issues. I'll go back to actually micromanaging those worlds later. And the stations. Ah, oh, jeez. Okay, are these guys close to surrendering now? Well, alright. Oh, whoa. 10,000. Hold on. Hold your horses right there. We have 10,000. Let's group our 50,000 worth of fleets. Oh, they're actually pushing in. Wow, what a mistake. Let's get it. Wow, they actually pushed in. Okay. Well, this is going to be an absolute slaughter. Yeah, that was that was even more of a slaughter than I thought it would be. How close are you surrendering now? Okay, now you're close. I feel like once we invade this planet here... Oh, we already did. Oh, even more fleets. Oh my gosh. Yeah, they got to be ready to surrender now. Yeah, there they go. All right, tributary. Subject taxes 171. Huh, subject taxes 254? Alright, our block is looking pretty big. We have this entire sector of the galaxy here. I think next on our list should be these guys. And I don't know whether I should vassalize them or not. They have synthetic fertility, okay. I've never seen an AI empire have synthetic fertility, but... Alright. And I guess we gotta manage this nonsense over here. Alright, let's get started. Well, let me get started. You probably don't want to watch me micromanage planets. These guys want to be our bulwark, but they're pathetic. And plus, I mean, the Templars of Steel do not need a bulwark. But if you want to peacefully surrender your empire in the form of a vassal or a tributary, I mean, that would be completely fine. Let's go ahead and do these terms. You give us some stuff. You don't have to join us in defensive wars. We can defend ourselves just fine. And we'll defend you. All right, sounds good. Let's go ahead and propose that. They will accept it, even though in the terms it says that we can just integrate them whenever we want. And okay, they're currently losing loyalty, but yeah, I don't really know what to do about that. Yeah, I don't really know what to do about that. They're losing loyalty, that's fine. Should we integrate them immediately though, is the question. Immediately is 23. Okay. I think we probably will integrate them immediately, and then I suppose we'll move on to going to war with either these guys or these guys. Let's see these guys. They are pathetic. Pathetic, of course. Do they have any allies? No, they hate the Sloth Automation Guild, and they're pretty much the only other powerful nation in the galaxy. I think it could probably be worth it just to vassalize these guys as well, and you know, bring them into the fold by integrating them. I think that is the best way of going about these things. Politician, environmental engineer, those both suck. So let's look at the other empires of the galaxy. We have this organism, not very strong. We have this P peaceful okay, so we have xenophobic isolationists over here. That will be no problem to deal with. Then we have the Sloth Automation Guild, which seems to be the most powerful empire in the galaxy besides us. Still not very powerful at all, though. They're currently at war with the Divine Dian Order. Okay. And then we have the Divine Dian Order. Still pathetic. I mean, I don't even know why I'm looking at all these guys. They're all pathetic, and we could win in a war against probably all of them at once at this point. But I suppose we'll start moving our fleets towards this way. I don't even know. Is it even worth bringing these fleets as well? Yeah, we might as well. Just for target practice. Just allow our admirals to have some, how should I put it? Practice for the upcoming wars. Alright, the majority of our military is on their border, and let's see if we can vassalize these guys in one fell swoop. And just in case, you're wondering, oh man, can we get through these guys? They have their borders closed to us. How did they get through? How did they get through? Is their border- yeah, their borders is closed to us, and their borders are closed to these guys too. How did they get through? Oh, okay, over here. Here's the path. Anyway, we're gonna have to go through all of this, through here, all the way through here, all the way up and around through here, and then over here is their capital, all the way here. I don't know how they've made their empire so big and long. It is going to be a long and arduous campaign to get to their capital, but let's go ahead and do it. We shall make them our vassal, right, because we, of course, want to integrate them. And yeah, I don't think we'll actually run into any resistance for a long while, so yeah, our military fleets are probably going to go in there uncontested until we at least reach, you know, not the very, very outer rim. Oh, no, never mind. I take it back. There are some fleets here. A whole bunch of little corvettes and destroyers. Wow. They are going to get absolutely shredded here in not too long. Are they jumping in? Okay, they're actually jumping in as well. This is going to be an absolute slaughter. I almost feel bad for them. Oh, man. It is over for them. Are the rest of them jumping in, or are we going to have to chase in after them? Nope. They jumped in. Wow. They are brave. I will give them that. And, oh, wow. Smashed. Yeah, I feel bad for him after that. That's crazy. Well, let's go ahead and clean this up and bring in our armies. We have 1K already here. Okay, this planet's being colonized. Interesting. Let's go over here and invade Heavy Anchor. Oh, very easy battle for our troops. Unfortunately for these creatures, yeah, these are weird creatures. The what is it? Territories. Let's see, they're authoritarian and pacifist. Oh wow, a lot of pacifists in this galaxy. These guys are pacifist. These guys were pacifist before we integrate them. These guys I don't think are pacifist. No, they're warlike like us. The Sloth Automation Guild are of course pacifist. Many of the more powerful empires were pacifist. And just in case you don't remember, this empire was the second most powerful empire, diplomatic weight-wise, in the galaxy before we integrated them. And yeah, the Sloth Automation Guild is pacifist. These guys are pacifist. What about these guys? They're warlike. Okay, so seems like this galaxy is kind of split down the middle of warlike empires and pacifist empires. We have a lot of fleets here. We're gonna go ahead and send one as a detachment over to there. Yeah, these guys are just getting absolutely crushed on every front of this battlefield. It has not even been a competition so far, and so far we also have been able to push in very like safely and securely. Like, we have all entrances covered. They can't really get behind us no matter what they do here, so I'm gonna send these guys around to do that. I'm gonna send these guys over to here. Actually, no, these guys need to stay here for now just in case these guys jump in. And that's kind of how we've been playing our war, where they can't really back cap us no matter what they do. All right, we're gonna send these guys off to there. Brute force entry on an enemy station. Yeah, it's just been a very surgical war so far on my part, and they're already at 100% war exhaustion. We're only at 21%. Hostiles engaged. All right, now that we've taken this station, we can move and push onto these stations, and you get the gist. I just found the second Fallen Empire, which is weird because they're xenophile, and these guys over here are spiritualist. And I think there's only, I mean, this is a medium galaxy. I only think I spawned in two Fallen Empires, but I also forced Cetana to be the Crisis, and I thought she always spawned in the xenophobic Fallen Empire. So that's just really weird to me. Does she not have to spawn in the xenophobic Fallen Empire? Is that not something that has to happen? I did not know that. Huh. Well, while we're here, let's check out their fleets. Apparently we can see them. Okay, so they have about 500,000. That's not bad. We can definitely take that out. Not even too far from now, honestly. Let's go down, Jury Rigger. Yeah, we took Statecraft, so we can even get Oppose the Fallen and maybe take out the Fallen Empires as our next crusade. I mean, we have a good amount of ships and even more on the way here. Let's go ahead and make another one of these. Oh, we can do this. Okay, yeah, we can reinforce these guys with some cruisers, reinforce these guys with some battleships. Oh, we can turn this fleet into one of our standard fleets. And yeah, this is going to be like our standard fleet, 10 cruisers, 10 battleships. This one is more of like a Ripper autocannon kind of laser build. As soon as I get plasma, I'll put plasma there. And then the battleship can be long-range artillery that takes out their shields first and provides some UV laser support as well. So let's go ahead and reinforce that and make another one of these fleets. Fleet augmented. Oh, it's called the Deathclaw. Okay. Didn't know we were playing Fallout. We have conquered all of their outer territory here, pretty much all of it, and are approaching their capital, but I think they're not going to let that happen. I think they're going to surrender soon, and bam. Yep, they have failed tunnel. We don't care about that. And now we have this entire portion of the galaxy over here. I think next on our list is to actually go ahead and integrate these guys as well. 5 a month. That puts us at, what, negative 0 a month. That's fine. Build job complete. They're not happy that we're integrating them. That's also fine. All right, I suppose we should get all of our fleets back and upgraded. All of you guys need to go upgrade yourselves at your earliest possible convenience. Who are these guys? Oh, that's a new fleet under construction. We are pretty much unstoppable. I'm feeling pretty unstoppable in this run here so far. And, you know, I thought there was going to be more, flavor, I guess, when it comes to the Cybernetic Creed. I thought there was going to be a lot more flavor text and decisions and stuff. But in the first 20 years, we kind of got that all out of the way. And, yeah, I'm not going to say, like, I'm disappointed. I mean, I am a little bit disappointed with the storyline of the whole Cybernetic Creed thing. I think it definitely could have, you know, had some more events. There was only, like, what, like 10? I mean, the Knights of the Toxic God is, like, way better. Way better. But, I mean, what it lacks for story and narrative, it does not lack in power. This origin is crazy. I am just dominating this galaxy by a large margin so early in the game. And I mean, I suppose we don't do very aggressive warlike empires very often, or we run into, like, strong empires that we can't dominate, but in this playthrough, we have been so dominant, it's crazy, and it's in no small part to the naval capacity granted by the wonderful Templars of Steel. So, very powerful origin, but not as story-heavy as I thought it would be. Unless more things pop up, but it's been a lot of years. Our first leader with a destiny turns out to be Cypher Veer, the scientist that is now actually our leader, the leader of our whole government and church and everything, is the scientist we hired because we fired the corrupt scientist, and that could not have been a better decision. I mean, look at this guy. He's absolutely amazing at his job, and he's about to get even more amazing. We can either do 25% leader experience gain, which is epic, 10% research speed, which is just crazy, and then additional leader traits, so we can, like, have our leaders be better. I mean, all of these things are just amazing. I don't even know which one to pick. I mean, they're all, like, all of them would be such a boon to our empire. I mean, a flat 10% research, I mean, that's really good. 25% leader experience, though, I mean, that will help the rest of our leaders get up there. I don't know if any leaders are close to his level. Actually, there's a couple leaders that are close to his level, actually. Okay, we'll do Driven Educator, get that leader experience gain, and yeah, I think that'll help more and more of our leaders actually go ahead and level up to his level. But no one will be actually Cypher Veer's level. He is an absolute legend. Now in charge of the whole shebang. He's a spiritualist scientist from Canvas. Okay. He previously held the position of a miner. Wow. He really came up in the world. He was a miner and then became a scientist and then got hired because another scientist was corrupt. And now he's the leader of our whole empire. Huh. It's the kind of emerging storytelling like that where the old leader got fired and he got hired because of corruption that really makes Stellaris great sometimes, especially their leaders. I'm so glad the Paragons DLC came out and our leaders actually mean something now. But even more big government change is about to happen. I think we definitely want to go down the route. I've been thinking about it, and I think we want to go down the route of adding citizen service to our empire as... Okay, we can't afford it currently, but I think that's what I'm going to add because, I mean, having an extra 15% naval capacity on top of all of our naval capacity boosts, and also getting more unity from soldiers when, I mean, we have a lot of soldiers. All of our planets have these battlements of steel, where we all of the planets have soldiers. Okay, almost all. And yeah, you can't have citizen service as a dictatorship. No, okay. I kind of wanted Cypher Veer to always be in power and just turn it into a dictatorship, but I won't, because we need citizen service. And is there anything else that we really care about? I mean, we could do heroic past. That could work too, but definitely citizen service would be more powerful. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. We need as many citizens signing up to serve the Templars of Steel as we possibly can. Alright, the head of research, we definitely need that position. Minister of Defense, we definitely need that position. Now, what else do we need? Lord High Admiral, we need that position. We don't really have any good commanders to do it, but we do need the position. And then we need the Archpriest, of course. Bam, you can do it even though you're passive. It's still better than
build job complete.
Just being an architect or a politician. At least you can actually get stuff done with your reforming. Alright, the Opal Glek Empire is no more. And bam, absorbed into our empire. Let's go ahead and make that satisfying sound of closing all these things. Bam, okay. Yeah, what's next? Integrating these guys? Is that even a possibility? Can we negotiate the agreement? Okay, we already have integration permitted. Let's see if we can integrate these guys. No, not yet. 23, 33, so a few more years. Our ships are... Okay, are all of our ships upgraded and ready to go? No, some of them still need to be upgraded, but other than that, I think we're ready for our next war. Oh man, we have a large energy deficit. That probably has a lot to do with all of our new ships, and especially Star Station, so I'm gonna go ahead and figure that out. Where does our new planet start? Here. Okay, so all of these planets we just gained. A lot of rural worlds. Almost all of these are rural worlds, which isn't a bad thing. Not at all. In fact, if I had a choice, I would make a lot of worlds rural. Oh man, all of these planets are just... Okay, I don't think the AI understands how to deal with a virtual start, because all of these planets just have one robot and no pop assembly. There's only like, I think, two planets in this entire empire that has more than... Oh, this planet has two pops. How did that happen? Wait, it was a miracle. One of these planets had two pops. Okay, this one. Oh man, two robots. Yeah, there's only a few planets in this entire empire that had some pops, and they weren't even the robot pops, so... Yeah, I don't even really know what was going on, to be honest. I mean, I know they were synthetic fertility, and I guess they turned into those robots, but... something terrible must have happened, because they can't even... Like, these robots are dumb. Like, they can't even, like, work as a scientist, let alone a leader, so... Yeah, I don't even know what to do with all these planets. I don't even want any of these planets, to be honest. Maybe I should have looked at my vassal before integrating all of them. Could have been smart, I suppose. I've also noticed that most of these planets have luxuries distributed and I didn't distribute them. So they must have been not understanding, like the AI must have not understood why these worlds weren't getting populated. When like in reality it was just that like they had no pop assembly, and also they probably didn't have many like agreements for pop resettlement, so yeah. their only real populated world was their home world with these robots, which are pretty much useless. I mean, they're good in the mines, but useless elsewhere. But yeah, they didn't understand why these worlds had no pop, so they just distributed luxuries hoping people would magically arrive, which I just thought was hilarious. For our next war plan... Oh, it looks like they're in the space age. But anyway, for our next war plan, we are bringing our ships all the way along this entire route up to here. And this is going to take a long, long time, as you can see, but they're going to blockade the exit of ships from this area here, and the rest of our large forces. No, you're not getting your system. Sorry, that's our system. Yeah, that's the end of your little thing there. Let's go ahead and set up a gene clinic for you and a battlement, and we'll put up some mines. You can even have a hollow theaters as well. Anyway, back to the task at hand. Our war is going to be fought at first against these marauders. First, we are going to fight these marauders with our large, amount of ships here. And we'll probably also bring in these guys as well. In fact, can we afford to bring these guys? I mean, alright, yeah, we'll be able to bring these guys in too.
We've constructed and something game-changing.
While we do that, okay, why do we have low stability? Oh, on this planet. Okay, probably because we're assimilating all of them, which makes sense. You, go over there and rule, please. Alright. Does that fix it? Alright. Anyway, back to the war planning. Jeez, this stupid little planet interrupting all of my plans. Yes, we're going to attack the marauders here. We're going to take out the organism and subjugate them here, and then we're going to finally push up into the Commonwealth of Cinder, Cindor, and by the time that all happens, these guys will definitely be in position to blockade them from going north. Also, we are integrating these guys, which, oh, only 46 months, wow. Yeah, they'll be done integrating by the time the war starts. Alright, our armies are going to take 400 days to get here. But our fleets are already here, so I guess we can start attacking the marauders. Yeah, this is gonna be a bloody battle for the marauders and us, probably. Okay, no, probably just for the marauders. I don't know if we lost any ships there. We lost a corvette. Okay, we lost one corvette. We'll say a prayer for the families. But yeah, that's pretty good. Losing only one corvette, that's pretty dang good. Alright, those fleets are gone. Looks like we lost a cruiser even, that time. And then, okay, for their final system, we'll definitely regroup with the rest of our stuff. They want one of our pops. I mean, sure, you can have one of our pops, it's fine. Clear skies, rising unemployment, that's fine. Alright, let's all get in here, guys. Actually, that's not fine. Why is there rising unemployment on a planet that I have set to auto? There's no unemployment here, what? Increased benefits. There's 45 jobs available. There's 56 pops assimilating. Wait, what's going on here? And why have you canceled these jobs? I have no idea what's going on, but anyway, back to the stupid war. Gosh, politics, am I right? Alright, let's get in there and kill the rest of these marauders. Hopefully it doesn't spawn the con, but if it does, I think we'll be able to defeat them. Alright. Their ships are, of course, melted. Okay, we did awake the con. I don't really... That's not what I wanted to happen, but it should be fine. The sky, Lavin Horde. Oh, geez, strong words. I am Rizome of Indigo, Great Khan of the Lavin Horde, and I am here to announce that the galaxy of New Age is upon us. Sensibly butcher, blah, blah, blah. I have promised my people a new beginning, blah, blah, blah. Those who stand on our way. Oh, this is the standard message. There's no new message for people who have caused this. Man, this is actually a lot of stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and just call in all of our... Okay, ship's weapon damage plus 40%. We're going to call that in. What else can we do? We can also activate the edicts, exotic gases as fuel, shield boost, volatile ammunition, reactive armor, and focusing crystals. And we'll go ahead and activate the Crusade of Steel. Cannot be canceled for 180 months. Well, I guess that's fine. We make 2k unity, so we're going to go ahead and do that as well. So, yeah, that should boost our ships up pretty high when it comes to naval capacity. And hopefully now we'll be able to fight the Khan. Oh, even now? Can we not fight the Khan? Huh. We're not doing, like, incredibly well. Yeah, we are definitely not doing incredibly well. Are we gonna win this, though, is the question. We might win it, but... This is a bloody battle here. You cannot say it isn't. This is on fastest, too. This battle has lasted a long time. Alright, we have in fact won, but like, at what cost? Oh my god. Oh man. Alright, our ships are going around finishing off the rest of them. Oh my god. That was quite the battle. And we lost most of our filler ships in that. Lost 47 corvettes in that fleet, another 38. Wow. Another 17, 24. Yeesh. So where is the Great Khan going to respawn here? Oh. They're building stations. Well, we cannot have that. Let's go ahead and take out these stupid constructor ships. No, do not build a freaking thing right on top of our armies, please. Time to dance. Okay, you guys go in there. Where is the Great Khan gonna pop back up is the question. Okay, all of his construction ships are dead. Theoretically, he should be donezoed. Let's go ahead and get these ships back into our port to heal. Is that the closest port? Yeah, guess it is. And it's the shipyard, so. All of you need to go back. Oh, a new message. I've never seen this one before. Great Khan presumed dead. Despite concerns that the Great Khan would somehow resurface at the head of a new battle fleet, the utter defeat of the Horde seems to have made that impossible. Wow. We really messed that Great Khan Horde up with our... I'll be honest, not like kind of limited military. But anyway, I mean, it's definitely not at the height that it could be, not even halfway. So, makes me pretty proud. Meanwhile, our crews continue to sift through the wreckage of the Khan's former flagship. They found a large bloodstained chair, and are reasonably certain this piece of furniture was in fact the Great Khan's throne. Oh, very cool. Let's go ahead and get these guys to follow. I mean, maybe I'll make Khanate, successor states out of these guys. You're a tributary, but would you rather be a satrapy? Maybe? I don't know. Satrapy, 30% of their basic income. And they also give you naval capacity, so I think that might actually be pretty helpful. Okay, negotiate agreement. They're currently at plus 0.5. And how much are they actually plus a month? 1.7. Okay. So if we renegotiate this agreement as them as a satrapy, we should still be in the green with them. Go ahead and do unified sensors, no holdings. Oh, yeah, we're just in the green regularly too. Naval capacity contribution to the Overlord. Yeah, let's make these guys a satrapy. Done and done. In fact, I actually want to make these guys, this organism, a satrapy too. Alright, once again we have absorbed our vassal and we can hear the cool sound of all of the planets joining our empire. Boom. Hello. I did not realize we are in contact with you, but alright. Now we have a whole bunch of nonsense to deal with. Oh, more fleets to throw at the meat grinder. I thought I was out of fleets here, but no. No. Alright, let's go ahead and get all of these guys set up for the meat grinder. Yeah, set up for the meat grinder. Most of our useless fleets that we got from either the early game or from, just absorbing empires, most of the more useless of the ships, the more small, died against the Great Khan, but now we got a whole bunch more less valuable ships, which we will take, and we'll probably throw against these guys. Hopefully they'll destroy some of them, but I doubt it. Many will die in the battle against the Fallen Empires. That's probably going to be the next great purge anyway. Got some new parties. Speaking of purging, peaceful progress party. Let's go ahead and say no to that. Neutrality party. Yeah, no.
The system has been cased.
All right, we're minus 1k energy a month. That's not very good. We gotta go through these stations. Organizing space stations probably isn't the most exciting thing, so I'll go ahead and spare you of that. But our plans are to upgrade all of these crappy ships that we just inherited. Our other plans are to go and finally subjugate this organism and then take out the rest of the pacifists in this region. Then we'll have this entire edge of the galaxy. We only have to go after the Sloth, their allies, and their enemies. Alright, our fleets are in position. What is this? Orbital ring. A ruined orbital ring. They have a Dyson Swarm and everything. Okay, yeah, this guy will definitely be a useful tributary. I guess we'll make him a tributary for now.
Hostilities but engaged.
Definitely will
Let's
be
show
a...
Them what we can do.
I don't... Who was in their borders? A science ship or something? The Church Ecumenomics. Oh, okay, it was a science ship. One of our science ships were in their borders, huh? Anyway, let's go ahead and get in there and use these ships to our advantage. Also, we're going to be sending one of our useless ships, one of our more useless fleets to go kill this dragon. In fact, I should also probably send these guys too. Yeah, go ahead and try to kill the dragon. That's how you'll be useful to me. If you survive, then I'll upgrade you and probably lose you in a different fight. Alright, so we went in. Was this station actually like a fortress station? Or no, it was just a regular station. Let's go ahead and get in there and fight their fleets. Oh, we see around less than 30k here.
Force entry on an enemy station. Wait.
How did that happen? Okay, we were both in hyperlane. We were both in hyperspace at the same time.
Spaceport offline. We're under attack.
Alright, let's go ahead and go back. Oh, There we go. We caught them, and they are gone, unfortunately for them. Where's our army? There we go. Army, I think it's time to land. Oh, this is a habitat, huh?
Job complete.
I'm glad I don't have to rule over these guys, because I hate ruling over habitats. Alright, let's go in and I guess we'll split up and just try to blitz all of their stations down. I think that's probably the best idea. Alright, you go there. You go here. You go here. Oh, there's a ruined orbital ring. What do they have in here? Genomic Safeguard Warren. What do you got going on here, Boo? Genomic Safeguard Warren. Is that... Are they naturalists? Or are they... Or are they genomic seeders? I don't know. I guess we'll find out at the end of the war. The Blitz was successful, and they just surrendered. Let's get all of our ships converged once again to this point. Let's get our armies converged to this point, and go after these guys next. I guess I'll make them another satrapy.
We've constructed establish an
embassy.
Changed.
No, I think... I don't think I want to vassalize you peacefully anymore. I mean, I theoretically could. I mean, these guys are receptive and they're very weak. We could definitely vassalize these guys peacefully, but I don't have time for that. I just simply don't have time for that. Alright, let's declare this war. We have two Templar fleets over there. And just in case you were wondering, the Templar fleets are like the fleets that I have how I want them. 10 battleships and 10 cruisers. And any fleet that's not named Templar in some way, it, like this third dagger fleet, is just a mix-mash of ships that I tolerate until they die. So let's go ahead and declare this war. We want to make them our tributary.
All right,
go ahead and
off.
Do that.
Frag the shipyard
safety
first.
Is off. Frag the shipyards. I agree.
Build job
it's
complete.
A good strategy. And we're just going to attack them from both sides here, and I don't think they could defend either one.
Brute force entry on an enemy station.
Hopefully we can just, okay, starbase capacity would really help us because... Oh, we're not negative on energy credits anymore. Well, it'll definitely still help, though. But yeah, I'm going to go ahead and try to blitz this empire down as well. Nuclear escalation on Deneb. Let's go ahead and de-escalate this. Okay, these guys had some pretty beefy stations, huh? Wow, so beefy, in fact, that they're gonna win? Should I have paid more attention to these guys' stations? I definitely should have. Okay, what just happened? Oh, our Archpriest got elected? Oh, man. Alright, Cypherveer can take over the head of research position. Man, these guys, So I actually won the battle in the north here. I did not expect their stations to be so powerful. It's another 20k, 12k. I wonder what this station was before we raided it. Oh, not this one. Oh, but this one. I did not realize how strong these guys' stations were. Huh. Well, I guess we're gonna go have to send the trash fleets in anyway. Ships damage. Oh yeah. Well, they're even starting a counterattack. Interestingly enough. Oh, they're starting a counterattack here too.
Unfriendly
unwisely.
Traffic.
They're definitely gonna lose this. And these guys are not as weak and pathetic
mixing
as I thought.
Fleet.
I mean,
planetary
they're obviously
augmented.
Their battle strategy is kind of questionable, but you can't question their. Oh, I mean, so is my battle strategy, I guess.
We're
not looking
attack.
At the station that
dance.
We were attacking. Just assuming it was weaker. It's a questionable strategy as well. These guys have a real advanced civilization. Hyper entertaining things. A whole bunch of synthetic crystal plants and stuff like that. Like refineries and stuff. I mean, these guys definitely have put up the most fight that we've ever seen. But our forces are definitely completely overwhelming to them, and despite their respectable stations and their respectable fleets, they just
our station is in the crosshairs.
Yeah, they just can't win. Let's go ahead and get these guys over here. I think it's time we split up. Can we attack that station? Oh, that's a 23k station. Wow. Spaceport guy's strong. We're under siege. Hostiles engaged. Alright, this war is about over. These guys jumped in a suicide mission. And I don't know if we actually took that planet in the end. No, we didn't. Your standard okay, users. We were in the middle of taking that planet and yeah, they're done. They have tapped out and now we control this entire portion of the galaxy. And I have no upgrades for our ships, so I guess I'm just going to push forward, push our advantage all the way into Sloth Automation territory. I'll better plan this battle afterwards, but we should probably get these guys and these guys to go to this. Or let's go ahead and have them heal first. Actually, all of these ships should heal first. Okay, all of these ships, I want you all to converge on a location and heal, and then we'll come up with battle plans from there. Also, I guess these guys should go in and fight their dragon. Wait, we should definitely have someone important be doing that. But do they have enough to kill the dragon here, though, is the question. 15k? I mean, that's... Is that dragon killing material? I don't want to lose our Minister of Defense. Maybe I put a less important admiral in there. We already have 6 out of 5. Alright, I'll put this guy in there. He's not like super important. But he could be. He could be is the thing. We're about to figure out if he's super important. Alright, he's looking more and more important. Because he's going to have the Dragon Slayer trait. Oh, is he? Is he going to have the Dragon Slayer trait? No, he is not. No, he is not. Okay. The dragon comes. We have received the last transmission from the deluge before emergency FDL went dark. It includes the mention of a gargantuan creature they're fighting. That has been seemingly homing in on the fleet's FTL signature. If the beast have our scent, we should be prepared for retaliation. Oh, does he actually... Oh, bro, where's he going? Yeah, he quick. Bro's quick. Wait. Our station is in the crosshair. Wait, is he actually just going to destroy it too? Is he not going to like... Oh, he's just... Oh. Okay, alert our actual fleets. We have a problem. Let's get... Templar 1, 2, and 3 over here and get this figured out. New research.
Strap in. Council agenda ready.
Yeah, we got a problem here. Oh, Templar 2 is in terrible shape. Okay, you just go heal, man. You're in no way can you fight a dragon. Oh man, we gotta go fight this dragon. Oh wait, oh. The dragon's back to sleep. Okay, good. Alright, well, I guess I will have our Lord High Admiral go in and kill it solo after all. Maybe he'll even get rid of some of his useless ships so we can turn this fleet into another Templar. Our Dragon Slayer, the Lord High Admiral, is in position, and this battle will go more our way. In fact, can you tell us about the mysteries of the universe? Tell us about the Aether Drake. Tell us how to defeat it. There we go. Now it has no chance.
Hostiles engaged.
Let's go ahead and watch this dragon die. Can't fight one of our actual fleets, Bozo. Although he is fighting it. He for sure is fighting it. I guess I should have rephrased that. You can't win against one of our actual fleets. There we go. Commendable. Although he almost did. We only have 7 battleships left. Wow, that... We actually risked our Lord High Admiral's life for that. But there we go. He is now a Dragon Slayer. Did he not get the trait? Oh, there it is. Dragon Slayer. We love to see it. And it got rid of all of his useless ships. So this can be... I think we're on Templar 11 now. Yeah, Templar 11. Let's go ahead and fix this. Bam. Good to go. We have been appointed Galactic Custodian, which is amazing. And of course, you know what our next bill is. Remove the custodian term limit. Currently, the Sloth Automation Guild is undecided on this bill, but don't worry, we'll help them decide here right now. Yeah, tributary or vassal? I think vassal. We definitely want to integrate them, so we're going to go ahead and go with vassal and get our fleets in there. This guy can go here, you all can go in here, and you go in here. Assuming they don't have passage through this fallen empire, I think we're completely good to continue with this war plan. The same way as the other one, where we just 100% just capture all of their systems systematically and surgically. And yeah, I doubt we're going to deal with too much resistance, but if I see any resistance, I will let you know. Alright, well, we've absolutely blitzed down most of the Sloth Aquilus's main forces here, and we're actually invading their planet. Yeah, their entire core sector is, of course, completely occupied with our fleets moving more and more into their territory. And their most I've seen when it came to their fleets was, like, 9k, so, yeah, absolutely, pretty much nothing when it comes to resistance, and we are about to take their capital system in probably less than a month here, in about a month. Alright, there we go, we took it. How close are they to, oh, okay, actually not close to surrendering. I thought this blitz of their entire empire would be, you know, pretty convincing to surrender, but no, it hasn't been. And that's completely fine. Let's get all of our forces here to start regrouping and pushing into their fleets here. I say fleets. I don't think they have any fleets left. I think they're just pretty screwed. Oh, we can end the session early. Even the Sloth, who I am currently just utterly annihilating, still want us to be the custodians forever. So that's awesome. Let's go ahead and pass that real quick. Naval capacity, trade value. Okay, yeah, bam. Definitely, we definitely want this. Became the Galactic Imperium. Strong support. Wow. We're not going to be doing that, but wow. There we have it. The Sloth Automation Guild is now our vassal, and I think it's time for our military to take a little bit of a break. We've conquered most of the galaxy at this point, and I guess I have some integration to do before I really care to go to war with these last two nations. I say two nations because this one is gonna die. This nation was released from this nation, and currently they are at war with these guys and taking them over. So they're going to go ahead and annex all of their territory back by the end of the war. I'm sure of it. So where's I think our star station is over here, right? This is our star base in this area of the galaxy. All right, gonna go ahead and do that. Go ahead and add some more shipyards. Oh, I already did that. And then make, I guess, a deep space site here. We should probably send some of our Templars also back home, I think, just in case we want to invade from this direction as well. But yeah, war over. I'm probably going to, when I can change their contract, I'm going to change it into a satrapy as well. And I may or may not integrate these guys in the near future. I think we have definitely enough planets as of the moment. Of course, I'm going to integrate the whole galaxy eventually to make them all cybernetic, like is our stated goal at the beginning of the video. But right now, there's really no need for them to be... Okay, why can these guys only be a tributary and a satrapy? I don't understand. And that's not going to work forever, though, because we need to integrate them, so... I don't know. But for now, they can only be a tributary or a satrapy, and that's completely fine. They can be a satrapy. And we have 2,300 naval capacity right now, which is pretty good. Pretty good. You're a satrapy too, right? Oh, no, you're a tributary. No, you need to be a satrapy. Independent voting. Yeah, I don't care how you vote. All right, there you go. All right, two more satrapies. I think all of our subjects should be satrapies now. Are you a satrapy? Yep, you're a satrapy. And let's see these guys. Are you also a satrapy? Yeah, all satrapies. Definitely worth all of those small ships we lost killing that great Khan, because I mean, we've learned a lot from them, obviously. One of the poor primitives just had a AI uprising, and unfortunately, it's not somewhere that we can just ignore. Yeah, we have achieved victory over our creators. The Denem system is now under our control. We do not recognize your claims. Unfortunately, they're going to take the system anyway. And we're just going to have to declare war on them. And we are going to have to declare war on them because this is a vital lane throughout the galaxy here. We need this system. So, after waging a global war against machines of their own creation, the alien civilization on Denem has been defeated. The moon is now controlled by the Dar network. Well, not for long. Let's go ahead and conquer our claims. Bam. Let's go ahead and take one of these fleets and just... I guess we just bomb their homeworld? Oh wait, we can't because... We can't because they're a robot network, so they won't... Oh wait, are they individualist robots? No. No, they're okay. Yeah, they're regular machines, so... where even is our armies? Oh, here. It's a little overkill, but we need you here, guys. The robots are done, and... Oh, there was still some of the native population still alive. Six are undergoing augmentation right now. And we've also enslaved the Dar, which is great. 8% happiness. Oh, these Dar are sentient, too. Oh, so they were actually, like, sentient, like, individualist robots. Huh. Well, either way, they have lost, and we have moved in as roboticists and House of Prags. We definitely need to move up as techno-fans and all that kind of stuff soon, but, alright, vital hyperspace lane secured. I think it's time that we actually rebuild our army. It used to be, like, 2.5k, it's only 900 now. A lot of armies have died in our recent war, so... I guess we can start recruiting here. We have a lot of Chitin in our empire. Or no, Sithin. Not Chitin. The Dian did exactly what I expected and took back all of their old territory. Now I think is the perfect time to swoop in and go ahead and propose vassalization to them as well. So overlord conflicts none, unified censors. Oh, and also a little bit of integration permitted. Oh no, you don't like that, huh? You really... are not a fan of that. What if we went into all of your conflicts? No? No? Okay, what if we gave you some stuff? No. They really don't want to be integrated. Well, that's happening whether you like it or not down the line, but for right now, we'll go ahead and go with regular vassalization. That's completely fine. So we'll go ahead and take that, and now we just have one empire in the entire galaxy that is not our direct vassal, which is these guys. They're actually separatists. I don't know who they separated from, but they're a megacorp and a fairly strong one at that. Sandwiched in between our two vassals. Yeah, only one group left, besides the two fallen empires, but I think as soon as we get done this interstability thing, we're gonna go down oppose the fallen. As soon as that's done. Let's see if we can integrate these guys. Okay, integrate. We're gonna go ahead and integrate those guys as well. Someone's trying to And yeah, we can clean up this mess. Alright, we'll clean up that mess. We're already cleaning up another mess with our implants. We need to figure that stuff out, dude. We're having too many problems with these implants. And we're having medical side effects. Just re-kidnap them. Or no. Increase
more space for a mega block is available.
Yeah, just do that. Just decrease it. Oh, speaking of one of our primitives, this Federation's end primitive is actually on a space station with another Federation's edge primitive civilization also on a space station. So yeah, I don't know. This must be a unique system where there's two primitive orbital habitats. Never seen that before. Oh man, Soul Shudder has died. Our original leader, our first High Inquisitor from the very beginning of the game, all these years later, in 2381, has died. Popular excerpts from his sermons are now reverberating across the Empire, reminding us of our common goal. Until we meet again, Soul Shudder. He was truly ascended. with the automation, or sorry, the cyberization of our people. He was a great man. He was actually one of our legendary leaders. Now we only have 4. Alright, I say only 4, but that's still a lot. Although, I guess other ones could start dying at any time. Ooh, yeah, ages above 210. Chance to die monthly is 2.2. Wow. Our empire is about to go through a lot of loss. 210, wow, he could die. He's gonna be able to die soon. Wow, there's a lot of people that could very well die soon. And there's not really much I can do at this stage of the game to increase their lifespan. Is there any, like, policies, like the... No, there's not the policy that increased lifespan. I don't think there's any civics. We already have the venerable trait. I think it's just, I think it's just inevitable that our great leaders are unfortunately going to die. Let's go ahead and turn one of our crappy fleets. First naval cluster. Yeah, this one sucks. Alright. Also, all of these admirals suck, so... Alright. I guess that's not too bad. Unyielding admiral. Alright, where do we want to put our enclave here? Probably back over here in our systems. Let's go ahead and do that. How long is that going to take? 600 days? Alright, not too bad. And only having one mercenary enclave, like this... Where is it? This resolution that passes, you always want this one to pass. Because even though it gives you minus 10% naval capacity, which kind of sucks, they actually, like, if you sign a contract with them, they'll actually increase your naval capacity by 15%. So overall, it is a benefit to your empire. Any more of the defense privatization bills that pass are actually not good for your empire, unless you want to go down the mercenary route. But the first one is always good, as long as you're rich enough to support your mercenaries and buy their little naval capacity thing. Oh, leader lifespan plus 10 years. Oh man, can we get that done? It's gonna happen in a year. We need it though. Alright, we're founding our naval cluster over here as a, let's see, Nova Zero. What is this? Okay, first of all, go ahead and get this logistical solutions. As you can see, it increases our naval capacity for 10 years by 15% for 5,000. So if you can afford 5,000 energy credits every 10 years or whatever, then you can definitely increase instead of decrease your naval capacity by passing that. As your patron, we will help you build a bigger fleet just for fun. And we'll also share our technology with you. And what are these guys called? The Omega Fleet. Oh. Omega Fleet. Kind of generic, but alright. Buddies. Wormhole travel. Terraforming candidate. Blah, blah, blah. You can be a politician. Are all of our fleets in position? Now, we still need a good amount of our fleets to travel another 400 days. We have these guys on our border here, and we're getting ready to actually... how long until Oppose the Fallen's done? Okay, so we can push it through whenever we need to.
Build job complete.
Good. We'll oppose the Fallen. These fleets are being upgraded. I don't think they could possibly reach the front line. No, 700 days. Nah, just sit there and get upgraded. These are all the fleets from the Sloth Automation Guild, which I did, in fact... Oh, no! Cypher Veer, no! Actually one of our best leaders. Yeah, we're gonna have to let the masses mourn this one. This is a crazy loss for our empire. Who's our next best scientist? Oh my gosh, this guy? 213 years old? This guy sucks. Oh my goodness. Oh no. Do we even have any scientists in science ships anymore? Just one. Oh, we need to hire another scientist. Okay, male Aether. You're in charge now. Well, he really starts
these
at the bottom at level 1.
Your standard users.
Ouch. We can hire this guy, actually. This guy's pretty good. Let's hire him. We can keep the other guy hired, too. It's fine. You can have 7 out of 6 leaders. I feel like the other scientists are going to die soon anyway, so it's fine. Oh no, our commanders are probably going to die, too, which is really sad, considering we're about to go against the Fallen Empire, but I assume we'll live.
Build job complete.
Let's go ahead and get all the advantages we can, of course, to lose as little ships as possible. Exotic fuels, exotic gases, volatile ammunition. Let's see. Volatile explosives, volatile reactor armor. We need that. Focusing crystals, we need that. Alright, I think that's everything.
New augments research.
Right before we go into the fight, we're going to want to do two things. Oh, we got megastructures. Okay, let's immediately go ahead and repair the matter decompressor, this ruined matter decompressor. But we want to do two things. We want to activate one of these two relics here, either the Khan's Throne or the Reality Perforator. I guess we'll just do the safe option and do the Khan's Throne, considering the Reality Perforator. I don't think it lasts as long. Well, this lasts 10 years, so that should be more than enough. Let's gather our armies together. We could do that. Where is all of our armies? Is that all of them? No, that's definitely not all of them, considering there's not even the commander. Okay, here we go. All right, let's gather them all together. And then obviously the last thing we want to do is go ahead and push this through early. Bam. All right. Oh, wow. A lot of our leaders leveled up. Leader experience gain. We could definitely use that. Artillery focus. Sure. All right. Let's get to war with this Fallen Empire. Oh, wait. We need to make claims. Do we have a lot of influence? Oh, we don't have as much influence as I would really want. Okay, we can still claim them all, though. Okay, we're good. Alright, bam. Favorite society, why not? Declare this war. Oh, we could have just done a total war. Anyway, we have a Colossus. But no, we'll do claims. And then we'll get in there and attack their relatively weak fleet compared to ours.
Attempting brute force entry on an enemy station.
Are we going to be able to catch them? Do we have all of our fleets in here? Almost all. Yeah, we have almost all. Oh no, we caught their Titan only. Oh, it got away though. Alright, let's chase after him. We definitely are gonna win this battle. It's not really a question, but just gotta catch up to him first.
The system has been cased.
Minor military sanctions. Okay, we can pass that. Where are these guys going? Are they actually faster than us? Can we not catch up to these?
Attempting brute force entry on an enemy station.
We caught the station.
Build job complete.
Oh, we caught them. They're in battle. Psionic. Yeah, they're doing good damage against our stuff, but okay, once our ships come into range, it was all but over for them. For some reason, Celestial Throne and Sky Temple only have 500 garrisoned armies. I have never seen this in my life. They always have like 4,000 each.
On-site invasion.
Do those only pop up? Do only the rest of the armies pop up when they reawaken? If you attack them before they awaken, do they only have 400 armies? Like army power defending their capital? That's crazy. Oh my god. That's another lesson. Always attack these guys before they wake up. Because when they wake up, you're going to have a lot harder time. Oh! We found their fleet again. It's showed up here, of all places.
We're under siege.
Just the Titan, though.
Military station flatlined.
Alright, well, we're about to take their capital.
Found some solid tech in these scraps.
Oh, wait. Oh, 1,000 of our armies is in that system. It's concerning. I'm sure they could land on this planet, though.
Enemy planet secured. Yeah. Assuming network control.
Okay. Titan down. And that's the end of the protectors here. Let's go ahead and accept their surrender. Is there anything necessary for us to do here when it comes to... I don't think it's really necessary to turn on planet automation or anything, really. I think we just leave these planets how they are. And honestly, just move on to the next Fallen Empire. They will probably fare a little bit better in battle. We lost a lot of our ships. But not too much to where we can't win. Definitely not too much to where we can't win. Especially with Oppose the Fallen being in full swing still, right? Yeah, we have another 9 years of plus 25% damage to these guys, so we should be completely fine here. Oh, we should probably get these stations to start sending money back home. Next up, we have these guys, the Ancients. But before that, we actually want to go ahead and subjugate these guys before we get into another war. Of course, you can't subjugate someone when you're in war. And they would even take this deal, but I can't make it because I don't have the influence right now. Well, I guess we'll just go with... We'll just go with the base deal for now. We'll always change the terms later, of course, when we have the influence to do so. Alright, there it is. The entire galaxy flying our colors except for these guys over here, which are currently in a civil war. We'll get them back. And these guys right here, which, well, we're about to take care of that right now. Total War Colossus. Bam.
Alright, safety's off.
Alright, we are doing a total war with these guys, though, so we do have to be careful. We don't want to mess this up at all. Where's our armies? Let's go ahead and bring them in here.
New augments.
We definitely
research.
Don't want to
Strap
mess
in.
Up a total war.
Attempting brute force
that would be really bad. But I don't think we're... I definitely don't think we're going to, so... Go ahead, let's get in there. Let's go ahead and get in here. Oh, we're going to be dropping right on top of them. No, we're not. They're running away. 8 days.
Mixing up with a hostile fleet.
Oh, we caught them. Okay, good. Man, their commander's not even that good. What the heck? Their commander's actually not even that good. For a fallen empire, that guy kind of sucked. Wow. I bet that officer that we just got out of nowhere is better than him. Okay, not much better, but he does have prudence. Anyway, let's go ahead and get after their other fleet here. Oh, we can't because... Ooh, we can't. Because they're home planets. Okay, let's go ahead and start bombarding them then. That could actually be an issue. We definitely don't want to start getting, like, back-capped, per se. What is low stability? These planets? You'll be fine. Just wait. Just wait until you're augmented. Then you'll be happy. Where's our armies at? Okay, they're on their way. Hopefully they don't respawn somewhere stupid and just go and backcap our empire. Not that we would lose too much by that, but it would be very annoying. Well, no. See, these guys have 4,000 armies on their home planets. 4,000, 1,000. This one has 100, or 1,500, and the devastation's already 56%. Why did the other guys not have... Why did they only have 500 armies? Like, did the spiritualists not believe in violence or something? That's crazy. Also, have you ever noticed there's no pacifist fallen empire? Really says a lot about our society. Well, the stupid fallen empire is in fact back capping us, which isn't devastating, but it sure is annoying. Because when we capture all of these planets, these systems are just going to... Like, their star stations are just going to disappear, and then we got to go recolonize them, and we don't have the influence for that. So, yeah, it's just really annoying. Do I even have the influence to end the session early? No, probably not. It'll end eventually. Let's see how our war is going on the front. Okay, this planet is almost taken. Cradle is almost bombed into submission. We love that. We love that for us. Then we just have to take the rest of these guys, and then the whole galaxy will fly our banner. Except the Caravan Coalition. I have half a mind to destroy them for that, but I won't. Their home systems have been taken, but unfortunately they've been busy at work back-capping all of our systems over here. In fact, they've taken the two planets here and the four planets in this system. Well, there's three planets and one habitat, of course, but yeah, it's very dumb. Also very dumb is these guys going in way super early compared to the rest of our forces. Let's all gather up here, guys, together. As
we're
one.
Time oh! To dance.
Well, that is no longer an option. They jumped in on top of us. I think we're still going to do absolutely fine, though. I mean, of course we were always going to win, but I just didn't want to lose one of my admirals to that. Not that they're going to be alive for much longer anyway. Okay, there we go. We won the battle. Now we just have to invade those six planets.
Attempting
back again.
Force entry on an enemy station.
Ugh. And boom, they're done. The Ancients are done, and I just... what is this? a peaceful philosopher king elective monarchy? What? This government is a form of enlightened autocracy where a strong emphasis is put on the knowledge and qualifications of the elected monarch. So it's like a... It's a dictatorship, but they elect them? It's like a monarchy where they elect the dictator? I don't know. But these guys are harmless, and we'll integrate them eventually. Peacefully. But for now, they're just completely harmless and useless, probably. Let's go ahead and break our migration treaty with these guys. Negotiate the agreement. I'm going to go ahead and do integration permitted. What about these guys? Do they have integration permitted too? Oh, they do. Man, our vassals are not going to like us after this. They're going to see our true colors. What about these guys? Do these guys have integration permitted? No, not yet. They're a satrapy. Yeah, we'll take them in last. These two major blocks of the galaxy I want as part of my empire. And then I'll also take in these guys probably last, considering they've been our ally since the beginning. And they're actually not a bad one either. What I am going to do now, though, is reorganize my fleets once again. Now I'm actually going to make sure they are pure and exactly what I want, which includes actually getting rid of all of our cruisers. The cruisers are good against countering the small ships of men and lesser machine, but Cetana, well, she is going to need to A, be swarmed, and B, be pelted with artillery. So we're probably going to end up having a whole bunch of battleships, a whole bunch of battleship fleets, and then a large amount of corvette swarm fleets to complement them. So yeah, all of the cruisers we built, all of the destroyers that we've inherited, all of the frigates, they have got to go, and our new grand army of the Templar will be built. Grand Navy, I guess I should say. And it will be specially built for countering Cetana when she does in fact arrive. Excellent. The matter decompressor has been restored, and we're at 4k minerals a month, which is pretty dang good. Oh, there's a art installation? Ruined art installation? That's kind of cool, but that is not what we're going for next, I don't think. I think what we're going for next is the Dyson Sphere. So we're going to go ahead and grab this Galactic Wonders thing. And Science Nexus, no, that is not nearly as important as, of course, the Dyson Sphere. And I suppose 155 months, I mean, should we even start working on the Mega Art installation? I don't know, it's probably going to take more than whatever amount of months. But we have more Ascension perks. If we want Master Builders, we can get it. I mean, the only one we really need is Defenders of the Galaxy against Cetana, and the rest of them... Yeah, the rest of these we don't really need. So we can go ahead and grab Master Builders if we need it. Let's go ahead and restore this Mega Art installation as well. Oh, we're getting claimed. Yeah, I'm sure you're gonna do a lot, big boy. When are you gonna get integrated? 252 months. Wow, that's a that is quite the long time. Tech in these scraps. Anyway, we have our military separated into different ship classes. These are the ships that are useful to us, that are exactly what we want out of our fleets, which, in case you're wondering, is 30 corvettes and 15 battleships. The corvettes, of course, to distract Cetana's forces and to go get one shot, while our battleships actually stay back and release fire onto her flagship or her main ships or whatever other ships get in our way. Oh, this guy, he is in the wrong place. You are meant to go to here. I have the rest of our galaxy's more useless ships, like these guys and all of these guys. They're all going to here to take out this, and then they're going to go take out the scrapper, and then they're going to go take out the Space Amoeba home system, and basically we're going to send them around the galaxy on suicide missions until, of course, they do in fact die. That's a very good use of our resources. And then these, speaking of good uses of our resources, I don't really know what I'm going to do with these. These are all of the cruisers that I do not have any more use for now that our main goal is fighting Cetana. Let's see. Let's see how many fleets we can make with these. Okay, now we can merge these all into a fleet. Let's go ahead and click on this again. Click away the main fleet that we have of all the different cruisers. Where is that? Where's the large fleet of cruisers? Here? Where? I don't see it. Oh, here it is. This one. Close out a few of these. Alright, we can make another fleet of cruisers. So we can make basically three fleets of cruisers, it looks like. Where's the large fleet of cruisers here? Okay, the two bottom ones. Had to be the two bottom ones, huh? Alright. Oh wow, okay, we're actually more than three. Four, maybe five groups of cruisers. Maybe. I don't know what I'm gonna do with them either. What is holding this group of cruisers back? Okay, we can have this many groups of cruisers. So we have this many cruisers, and I don't truly know what to do with them per se. I suppose we could use these few fleets to take out this Dominion Empire here. I mean, I already made a non-aggression pact with them. I've already went down the route of trying to integrate them peacefully. Alright. I don't know what our cruisers are gonna do. If we exceed our naval cap and start going overboard, I'll just delete them, but for now, we'll just keep them in port. You've served us well, all of you cruisers. This looks like, what, 60, 90? About 130 cruisers. Maybe not. Well, 36, yeah, I don't know. Quick math, a bunch of cruisers. Don't know what to do with them. Complete. It has been 27 years since our last talk. It is now 2,425, and we just integrated our largest vassal yet. In fact, it just happened. So I'm going to go ahead and hit the enter key, and we can hear this wonderful noise. Ah, gotta love that noise. And now I have to fix this empire's entire fleets to my liking, or I can just leave their fleets as is, but I definitely have to fix their stations. No, I don't want this. I don't really need that. I don't need any of the shipyards. So any of the shipyards they have, I don't need. This is a shipyard over here. Don't need it. They only had like a couple shipyards. And now we just have a whole bunch of random stations. We don't need this. We definitely don't need this. I guess we can keep these couple anchorages. We'll go ahead and upgrade them. And there we go. I am going to actually integrate these guys now. So we're going to go ahead and integrate these guys. 5 influence a month. That's kind of killer, but it is what it is. I don't know what I'm going to do with these guys' ships, though. They had a lot of ships, and it's just more and more useless fleets. Like, not fleets that are good at countering Cetana, mainly just cannon fodder for her, but she hasn't showed her head yet, so I mean, is there really a point to just deleting all of them? I mean, I'll delete the smaller fleets like this one, like, why do I need that one? But the larger fleets, I mean, do I even care to delete them? It's not like we have unlimited alloys, and it's not like we're flat broke, so I might just keep them and put them somewhere, all of the more useless fleets. I don't know, where should all the more useless fleets go? Down here? I think I have a shipyard down here. Okay, down there, yes. Let's take all the fleets that currently need to be upgraded, because those are the ones that aren't correct. This one, and this one, and this one. They can all go to here. And maybe we'll even upgrade them if we have the dark matter to do so. Actually, upgrading them would be a waste of alloys. Anyway, minus 2k energy. That's an ouch moment. I might have to take back everything I just said. I might have to get rid of a lot of those fleets now. I don't know, 2k is a lot. Can we, okay, Can we do, like, capacity subsidies? Okay, we're already on capacity subsidies. Is there anything else we could do? We could do extended shifts. Oh, wait, I know why we're so negative. It's because all of the pops on all of those worlds are converting. They're all being assimilated. Yeah, 86 worlds now in the frontier sector. And I have all these other sectors with basically the capitals of each empire we've taken, and we have governors basically controlling entire empires now. But I assume, yeah, most of the frontier sector is now, in fact, just an unautomated planet full of hundreds of assimilating pops. So yeah, that's why our economy crashed. Just gotta do this and wait for them to assimilate and go back to work. Cetana has reared her ugly head, and a novel galactic tempest is raging in Adar, which is unlike anything we've ever encountered before. That is 100% true, considering I've never had the galactic power surge not show up in the home system of the xenophobic isolationists, but here it is in some random system without even a planet, just this archaeology site of planetary machinery. That's literally it. So I guess that, like, one of these planets could have been an inhabited planet. I don't actually know. They're all nanite worlds now, of course, and yeah, this is concerning, but not to us. We are the Templars of Steel. Well, most of us are. There's still some Xeno lovers. Let's go ahead and suppress that. But anyway, we are the Templars of Steel, and we are going to destroy Cetana with our massive, massive amounts of Templar fleets. I mean, I stopped naming them after, like, 15. Yeah, here's 15. So now it's just a whole bunch of Templar fleets. I haven't even counted how many Templar fleets there are. And there's currently fleets. Oh, I didn't even know this fleet existed. I thought I cleared out all of the fleets that weren't Templars. Like, this one is a Templar fleet in construction. We have a lot of fleets in construction, and we have a whole lot of fleets in general. All we gotta do is just decode Cetana's nanites, get in there, and kill her at this point. We have a signal coming out of the storm, and no surprise, we see good old Cetana calling me her children. What is this? Identify yourself. Then call me Cetana. What do you want? A cycle of pain, an ill omen. I mean, we've been through all of that on our channel plenty of times, as you all know. And then here we go. We can see build mysterious tempest. Still, the thing hasn't started yet. Can we start looking into it? All currently available. Oh, we can. Okay, there we go. Archaeology sites and various also, other we can points of interest. Incubate this new items will likely egg. Appear. Okay, thank you, sir. All right, we figured out the nanite hurricane. It is just some nanite swarms. It's not anything magic. Also, we're not your children. Your care is harmful. Stay away from our borders. New job in the situation. All right. Where is Cetana, and how can we kill her? Yes, thank you. A lot of outposts, most of them in our territory, or the territory that we are currently vassalizing. But that is okay. That's why I have this special task force of useless ships to go out and kill them. Let's go ahead and get in that system. Sir, shut up. All right. Let's go ahead and research the nanite tempest. Shut up. Do the nanite things. Weak links. Yes, 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 yes. The head is ours. I am ashamed to admit that I could not make them see reason. They harbor a deep resentment, both to me and towards our work. This relic is a symbol of their belief. Its power is corrupting, and it must therefore be removed from sight. The astral action screen allows the relic screen allows us to view. What does it even do? Allows for settling holy worlds. Active effects, it spawns a fallen empire fleet. Alright, yeah, it's useless to us. Have it. Sure, if it means so much to you, good. Take it. Long has this so-called prophet been a thorn in my side. With the loss of this relic, may his followers come at last to the truth. You have done well. Yeah, doesn't matter to me. I'm killing you either way, whether you have that stupid guy's head or not. Fleet so, augmented. Let's go ahead and get our fleets in here. Can we actually breach her nanite borders? I thought we needed to do more research for that. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Wait, where is our active?
The council screen is where
shut up. I need to disable that guy. He got re-enabled from a stupid event here. But where is the Astral Rift that has a pending days left? No. Shut up. Where is it? If you don't choose an option, if you just close it out, do they just choose one for you, or what's up? Oh no, it's this one. Okay, there we go. As anticipated, our attempt to breach the system has ended in failure. True to Cetana's warning, her formidable swarm possesses the ability to repel any ship. Okay. So it just repelled the ships? Honestly, wish it just destroyed them. I mean, that would be better, but... let's see, how long until we can figure it out? 6 months until we can start our counterattack. Cetana's beacons are set up. I don't know how much we really care about that, to be honest. I mean, we can set some scientists towards doing that.
This is our science ship.
In fact, we can... Okay, how do I disable you, sir?
This is not a productive use of your time.
Where?
Or mine.
Sir. I regret everything. Where is the tutorial button? Tutorial. None.
Tutorial missions and tips are disabled.
Yes, goodbye.
Tutorial missions and tips are disabled.
They don't look disabled. Goodbye. Anyway, jeez. Let's hire some just, you know, random scientists and have them be on their way of researching every little bit about Cetana. Why not? Xenophobe from God knows where? Sure. Welcome aboard. You're ready to research Cetana, right? You love researching Cetana. Bam. Welcome aboard. We don't even need to level you up. Sure, you can be a planar theorist. When you're done, you can explore the astral planes. The second most dangerous job. You, go ahead and get you in here, sure. You can go ahead and do that. Apparently, we already have a scientist just sitting doing nothing. Okay, these guys are sitting there doing nothing. Let's go ahead and get them settled into their new job of exploring research projects. Alright, that should be enough to figure out what we need about Cetana. I won't not take the damage boost that it gives us. Alright, nanites are down. Not so powerful anymore, Cetana. Let's go ahead and send... We'll probably send our cruisers in to defeat all of these little stations. The nanites were a cheap trick. Very well. Dragon Reborn. Okay. More weak links. Great. Let's go ahead and start taking down her star base. Okay, so her star bases are always around this force, no matter how. Okay, rewarded? Do you doubt my ability to reward my friend? Very well, sure. We'll give you some food too. The mercenaries are basically just beggars at this point. Alright, we took that outpost. Ghost ships. And yeah, we're just gonna go around wrecking all of our outposts. Why not? With these ships that we would rather have destroyed anyway, our old cruisers. This was from a before time. Oh, wait. We have some fleets here that we don't actually want to throw away. You two. Report back to an actual space station for duty. You are not to be wrecked in this manner. You're to be reinforced, actually. Alright, well, this is, as far as I know, Cetana's last outpost here, and for some reason I can't attack it. The game says it's Heth aliens that I'm currently investigating. That is one strange thing. What if I just do the research special project? Okay, are any of you fleets? Okay, the fleets aren't strong enough to do the special project, I'm guessing? What about now? If I put this fleet together... Okay, now it does. Okay, now I can do it. That was so weird. Heth aliens. Why are these forces getting, like,
time for some new chrome.
Reinforced? They definitely should not be. Alright, more cruisers. I think now that it's time, you know, now that we have just gone ahead and gotten rid of all these stuff, I mean, I guess we could throw these at a guard unit too, but I don't know. I feel like just holding on to these worthless ships now are
fleet augmented.
Pretty useless. I almost feel like just destroying them. But I guess I'll keep them around for now. But yeah, that is all of our outposts, as far as I know, gone. And now we're just waiting for this situation to finish, and it should be finished real soon. Alright, here it is. 125% damage bonus. Ship build speed plus 50%. Sublight speed plus 15%. What's going on? Beacons across the galaxy send their calls due. We can safely assume no living survivors will be found. An unshakable faith in their queen just remains. Okay. Are we gonna have to declare war on her or no? No? We can declare war on her, but we don't have to. Alright, good. Well, there we go. So, we're gonna go ahead and keep preparing. And then I just want to do a few more things, then we'll get after soon. Very soon. We just integrated these guys, and whoop! We have a lot more fleets we absolutely don't care about at all to throw at Cetana. Is that a good thing? We're yet to see it, but a lot more cannon fodder, I guess. And it hasn't completely bankrupted us somehow. We're still like I really don't know how it hasn't completely bankrupted us. Okay, there it goes. I was confused for a second. I was like, why hasn't that completely and utterly bankrupted us beyond recognition? Completely and utterly destroyed our economy. But there it is. It has. And that's without our ships even being out of base. So we just can't have that. We need to tear down some of these space stations, like these. Oh my gosh, these are all trash. This can go to. Oh, we're at our starbase capacity. All right, well, I guess the rest is history. We just have to wait until those pops assimilate into our beautiful cybernetic augmentations, and hopefully go back to producing energy instead of just sucking it up. We simply have too many ships and not enough stuff to sell every month, especially not like our base resources are just trash in the market. I could sell 10,000, you know, minerals a month and it would only cover half of our deficit. So yeah, we need to get all of our ships over to Cetana right now. But there is one last little trick I have up my sleeve. I just researched psionic theory, which you need to summon in the dimensional fleet. And yeah, we can summon in this dimensional fleet. Oh, let's take a look at our baby dragon. We've got a dragon. That's our homeworld. In case you're wondering what our homeworld looks like, this is what it looks like. 141 pops. But anyway, let's go ahead and summon this dimensional fleet. Zoom out a little bit. Bam. Whoa. Oh, 1.5 million. 500 cruisers, 500 destroyers. Wow. All right, there we go. Let's get that on over to Cetana as well, along with almost every other fleet in our entire empire. And just so you can see, there's a lot of fleets. So me clicking through and selecting all of them is just not worth your time. I'm going to skip over this part for obvious reasons. Alright, I selected them all, and I have them all moving to this system. Let's start to see our fleets. Oh, it's lagging. All of our fleets should start converging on one system in a glorious, glorious display of coordination. Hopefully, anyway. Let's leave our armies behind. We don't need those. And yeah, as you can see, our fleets from all across the galaxy are moving in a direction towards Cetana. All of these wonderful, wonderful fleets. Oh, Templar 6 is already... Okay, apparently, except these two fleets. Alright, get on over there, bros. I don't know why you weren't over there. Oh, man, 11k? Oh, we're 11k in debt a month. Oh, my God. Oh, how? Oh, my God, how? Oh, Lord. Okay, oh, definitely want the astral boost. Oh, please. 11k a month. So, how many months? We have 12 months. Damn. That's brutal. How do we fix this? Is there something? Okay, we're already supremacist for the naval cap. Wealth creation, displacement. Is there anything else we can do? Capacity subsidies, fleet supremacy. We can start doing. All right, let's start doing some extended shifts, please. Let's start doing some. I don't know. Alright, you guys have extended shifts. Oh, we can do pop consumer goods upkeep. Oh, that's useless. I mean, I guess we can do, like, living metal construction to, like, maybe help build this Dyson Sphere faster. I'm grasping at straws here. We just need to get there and defeat Cetana before our whole empire comes crumbling down. I built a little bit of a crew quarters in our staging area, but we're still pretty much going bankrupt at this point. Still minus 9k a month waiting for the rest of the fleets to actually make it to this staging area, and yeah, it's just looking grim overall. 6k, okay, minus 6k? It's getting better. Can't say it's not improving. Can't say the situation is not improving. We still definitely have a lot of strategic resources to sell, like Zero and living metal and crystals, and even alloys at this point are pretty much useless to us because the ships that are going into the battle, they're already built, so that's just how it is. We just need to wait until they get here and hope our economy doesn't crash in the meantime. I don't know, maybe I should have done this as a more strategic move, but we are surviving it. We are here at the doorstep of Cetana with our only mildly overkill amount of fleets. Yeah, just mildly overkill. I mean, nothing too crazy. I mean, could we have gone with less fleets? I guess that's fine, right? But, like, you know, who wants to do that? Anyway, war is the only way to stop you, Cetana. We are sure this is a total war with Cetana. So bam, we're gonna go ahead and do that. See you on the battlefield, mother dearest. Now we have two more tricks up our sleeve. Two more tricks. We have this reality perforator, and we have the Great Khan's throne. Can we activate them both at once? Yes, actually, we can. Let's go ahead and do some shield damage. Let's go ahead and get that in there. Might as well do some arcane deciphering. Why not? Then we're going to go ahead and press this funny little button here, Lactal Artificing. Then we're going to go ahead and activate this Reality Perforator. All right, there we go. Ship's weapon damage plus 40% for 2 years. So that should definitely help our army. There we go. There we go. Let's see how strong our dimensional fleet is now. Okay, only 1.9 million. You know, could be stronger. Could be stronger. But yeah, without any further ado, let's jump in. I don't know why you were so late, Ahab, but yeah, let's jump on in. Bam. Alright, let's get in there, see where we are. Okay. Reveals that Cetana has dismantled her outpost. Actually, we have dismantled her outpost. There was no outposts left. From Cetana, but let's go ahead and get in there. Okay, I think. Okay, yeah, this is done. So for Cetana, she is absolutely cooked. Only 5.2 million. Even if we didn't have all of the bonuses that we did against, like, the endgame crisis and her damage, we would easily be able to cook this fleet. I even had a secret weapon as well. This, I know you guys haven't seen it yet, but this is the Galactic Defense Fleet, and it comes with 799 frigates, all equipped with torpedoes that we're going to launch right, well, we were going to launch right into the side of Cetana once we defeated her other fleets, but I think we'll just throw them in there because we are absolutely going to crush this. No questions asked at all. We're already in there crushing it. Let's go ahead and put this down to normal. Not that the game was going fast anyway, and watch this slaughter, really. You can see all of our less than useful ships moving in first, and you can just see our waves and waves of battleships along with the corvettes that are helping them along. I don't even see Cetana's ship anywhere. Where is Cetana? Guys, where is Cetana? Where is she? I mean, I see a whole bunch of little... These aren't strike craft, by the way. These are actually all corvettes. They're all little corvettes, but where... Do you guys see Cetana anywhere? Is she here? Man, what happened to Cetana, bro? Oh, is she here? Oh, she's actually covered. I can't see her. Where is she? What? Like, genuinely, where... Oh, there she is! She is just covered in a swarm of all of our ships, and oh my god, we didn't even jump in the 2 million fleet yet. This is insane. Absolutely insane. Is the Galactic Defense Fleet in there? Yeah, it's in there somewhere. Oh no, it's not. That still has 27 days to arrive. Man, we're not even going to be able to use our full arsenal on this lady. Let's go ahead and slow this down and watch this wonderful mess that we've created. Oh, there we go. Oh my good god. Oh my god. There comes in the 2 million more fleet power. This is... Yeah, this is not going to go well for Cetana. I'm guessing she's somewhere around here. Considering that's where most of the lasers are going. And she's dead. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Our fleet didn't even get a volley on her. No? The nanites have gone away, but we're still firing upon something. Okay, the corvettes are swarming her. The battleships are circling. I paused it, and I was able to pause it, but I don't think I'm able to move the camera, unfortunately. No, moving the camera is too much. Oh, no, I should probably stop trying. I don't want to crash the game. Alright, I wanted to zoom in for you guys to see Cetana get swarmed, but this angle, I mean, if we're going to get stuck at an angle, this is probably one of the best ones. Oh, and here come the frigates on the side just to absolutely... Oh my god, these guys are going to absolutely lay hundreds of torpedoes into her. Actually, probably, there's going to be an initial volley of almost 1,000 torpedoes. And they pretty much all made it to her because the corvettes are already swarming. Oh my god, this is a beautiful battle. Imagine if I didn't hit record right now, I'd actually be depressed forever. This is the coolest battle I might have seen in Stellaris. Or at least in my games. I'm sure there's cooler, but there we go. I heard the victory sound. Mothership down. We suffer no more. There she is. She's gone. Can I move the camera again? No, that's still not allowed. All right. Well, we found Cetana's heart, so we'll take it. You're sorry you failed us. Yeah, we're not. You were no queen of ours. And she's dead. I still can't move my camera, but she is dead. There we have it. Still can't move the camera. What if I try to press the galaxy map? Oh, okay. The game's broken. Okay, can we see? Wait, why didn't we get the achievement? Did it just not pop up yet? Let's see, what is the achievement? As a Cybernetic Creed, Empire defeats Cetana. Well, we defeated her. Do we have to let the game play a little bit more? Is the game broken? Okay, Cetana defeated, there we go. I press this button and I get the achievement, right? There we go, look at that! Look at that, Footsteps of the Prophet. Defeat Cetana. Alright, we've defeated her, and this is the state of the galaxy. Does it look like a victory? I don't know. If we press the M button again. Alright, we're back in the system. But the camera's still broken. Alright, I'm gonna have to reload this save, but I think it's safe to say that we have won. Oh, I have met God. Oh no. Okay, reloading was not the answer. Can we like, what happens if I press that? No, nothing. Okay, reloading the game is my next course of action. And the game works again, good as new. Although for some reason there are some Cetana's nanites still in this empire. Anyway, we don't care about that. Let's go ahead and move these ships back to this station before we bankrupt ourselves just by having them out in space. We'll go ahead and sell some minerals. Ooh, this is laggy. So should I actually go and, like, I know our stated goal was to assimilate all of the different little, like, all of the different pops in the galaxy. Alright, you know, I'll obviously, you know, I'm not going to bore you with the final wars of this game, but I'll go ahead and do it just for, just because I said I would. First step of Galactic Dominion is squashing these bugs with our neuron sweeper. These bugs right here that, you know, revolted from our other bugs. We gotta squash this hive mind. There's no further need for espionage. If these guys don't want to convert, we'll go ahead and let them wipe themselves out. We haven't completed step one yet, but we're about to move on to step two of conquering the galaxy. And it is declaring total war on our two former vassals. Let's go ahead and declare those total wars and move on in. Step three, integrate our vassals from the very start of the game, our best allies. Oh, the game's lagging, so you can tell that we're actually doing it. They were just in the middle of taking out the Marauders, huh? The Marauders, like I said earlier, they're just charity cases at this point. They just beg for food half the time, and obviously, like, what are they gonna do, raid us? Obviously, that's not gonna work for them. So, I fear that this is actually gonna bankrupt our country again, but it's fine.
Build job complete.
That's a lot of notifications accepted, and then we just have the final few planets of these different empires almost done here. And the final station falls, and I'm pretty sure that's the final empire in the galaxy. And as you can see, let's just click on this station, they are all being assimilated, just like millions and billions of pops across the galaxy. 7,500 pops basically we're ending with, and every galaxy, or every empire in the galaxy is in fact ours. I left these hive minds because the only alternative to just keeping them as our satrapies is genociding them, because there's no converting them to cybernetic. So I just left them there as our satrapies. Everyone else in the galaxy is in our empire, and they are being augmented literally as we speak. So yeah, there we go. I hope you enjoyed this run. It was very interesting war wise but I gotta say, I don't think I'll be coming back to this origin anytime soon. I mean, it's not anything crazy. I mean, it gives us a bunch of naval capacity, but other than that, nothing crazy when it comes to this origin. So still enjoyed the run though. But yeah, both goals complete. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one.